continues into September. I haven't really covered it like I should. There have been some new developments. That's coming up today. We're going to get into an earthquake hitting in the middle of Colorado, and they're saying the big one in San Francisco could be right around the corner in the Telegraph. There's a lot of geopolitical news and more today, but first, Paul Watson reports on some of the giant distractions that are out there as they weaponize the media and try to absolutely confuse the population.
Is prominent Black Lives Matter activist and self-help guru Sean King the next Rachel Dolezal? Conservative news websites are abuzz with claims that King, who says he is biracial, is actually white and has been lying about his ethnicity all along. King claims he was terrorized at school for being mixed race, but a 1995 police report identifies him as white. Police also dispute King's claim that he was brutally beaten by rednecks in a racially motivated attack, which King alleged was Kentucky's first hate crime. Records show the incident involved only one other person and that the injuries were minor. A birth certificate obtained by Breitbart from the Kentucky Office of Vital Statistics also names a white man as King's father. Blogger Vicky Pate uncovered this photo of King as a child, which appears to show a Caucasian kid with ginger hair. Even King's Daily Coast colleague Burt Miles wrote a blog in which he said he was very concerned about King and his motives. Key documents appear to show that King has two white parents and that he has been lying to the public about his race, reports Breitbart. Whenever King is quizzed about these claims on Twitter, he immediately goes on a blocking spree and refuses to address the issue. King finally responded to the story earlier today on Twitter, asserting that it was a white supremacist conspiracy theory and that it was, quote, bullshit. Although when asked directly, over and over again, whether he was white or biracial, King only said that his family history was a mess and that he will never go public with his racial story. So why does it matter whether Sean King is white or biracial? Because he's become a darling of the Black Lives Matter movement and the leftist media on the basis of a personal story that may have been completely contrived. He's also closely affiliated with D. Ray McKeeson, who many see as the de facto leader of Black Lives Matter. This would also cement the existence of black privilege. Just like Dolezal, King has exploited his assumed ethnicity to further himself, possibly at the expense of other African Americans. King cited his ethnicity in order to obtain a black-only Oprah scholarship to Morehouse College. Could King have misled Oprah, an African American icon? We've also had months of browbeating telling us that gender is a choice and not a biological absolute. Gender is far more biologically rooted than race. So now thousands of young Americans could claim they identify as black, assert their black privilege, and start demanding places at prestigious colleges. As Alan Bakari notes, King could be the latest example of individuals who covet the status of victimhood in order to achieve moral infallibility. By pretending to be oppressed, these professional victims can assert superior virtue in the public arena and enjoy the privileges of lavish, unquestioning media coverage and a plentiful supply of educational and job opportunities. Meanwhile, the genuinely oppressed continue to suffer without a voice. So what do you think? Could this scandal lead to the fall of Black Lives Matter if it is indeed revealed and confirmed that Sean King is the next Rachel Dolezal? Let me know what you think in the comments below. This is Paul Joseph Watson for Infowars.com.
We're live, ladies and gentlemen. Thursday, the 20th day of August, 2015. We're going to cover some key news. Hillary Clinton is on the rocks and could be going down. Everyone can smell her political blood, her lifeblood in the wind. She is wounded mortally if we simply press the case. And CIA, retired CIA contractor just a few years ago, very famous, part of the Iran-Contra hearings as well. Robert Tosh Plumlee will be joining us with his new questions for Hillary Clinton. He's published on Facebook. And Robert Tosh Plumlee will be taking your calls in the third hour. Dr. Edward Group will be in studio. And he's not just a doctor. He's also a nutritionist and a lot more. And we'll be taking your questions and comments on health issues and other health news, Obamacare that they're trying to keep in place. He'll be joining us in the second hour. We will have open phones throughout that entire hour, interspersed as well. That said, today's news is particularly heavy and important. I want to attempt to go over all of it in some detail. U.S. to preposition tanks, artillery in Baltics and Eastern Europe. The U.S. Defense Secretary announced yesterday. Very big news. Because that's already happened, but now they're admitting it. Huge escalation. North and South Korea exchange artillery fire today. This happened about 2 hours ago. That's out of Reuters. As that situation escalates with the North promising to basically bombard and attack the South. Now, they've done this before, but that regime is on the edge of collapse. Many analysts believe this is exactly when you would see some type of psychotic behavior by the demonic, spoiled, third-generational communist that runs that dark age country. That's coming up. I covered this story a week and a half ago when it broke, but now I'm working on this with some other folks that have photos and videos that we're going to be obtaining in Texas and other states of similar activities. Special ops soldiers use rental trucks to infiltrate and occupy California town. For some reason, last week when I got back, I was jet lagged and I made a mistake, so I want to correct that now. I'd got it in my mind that Jade Helm was running from July to August 15th, and then I thought about it later and checked. And then I was also corrected by Nico. It ends September 15th, and I knew that. It's just sometimes I flip things around in my mind. And I want to talk about some of the true developments of Jade Helm that have been taking place. You've heard the callers calling in who've been confronted by military personnel and told to turn their cameras off or they'll regret it. That's happened to myself covering some of these events. And these type of activities are happening all over the world. In Spain, a fellow got a large fine for on his Facebook saying the police are so lazy that this local department, they should be given swimming pools and hammocks. Thought that was free speech in Spain. He was fined thousands of euros. Now a woman is even in more trouble. Spanish woman fined 900 euros for posting picture of police parked in handicap space to Facebook. And we have footage of this that we need to go ahead from the trip and put out. We're putting in a documentary as well. They made us erase it in front of them, but we were able to salvage it off the memory stick. There was a cathedral, famous cathedral, and police were like 50 yards in front of us, part of the shot. And we were getting shots of them repairing the cathedral with these big cranes and bricks going up and down. It looked like a Richard Scarry illustration. We weren't even actually trying to get cops on tape. Though there were cops standing around with machine guns, and they came over and started speaking to us in Spanish, and I said, I speak English. He goes, oh, you speak English? You're so big. Well, so do I. And I went, look, we're just Americans. We're just here, filming, and don't mean any trouble by it. And he said, well, I could take you to jail for filming us. I mean, that's like Nazi Germany, or that's like Soviet Russia. And this is happening in the heart of Europe. They're going back under a monarchy, under Juan Carlos, who was given power by the dictator Franco when he died in the 70s. It's really just unprecedented, and our media isn't making a big deal out of it. Like when China used to sell political dissidents' organs 20 years ago, it was a big deal. It would at least be in the news. Now they just go, big deal. So it really shows a hardening of the conscience, a hardening of the heart. And when you have that, you have no empathy, so we'll be breaking that down. Joe Jennings came in today, and he said, you're not going to air the latest Planned Parenthood video, are you, today? even more footage of small babies and large babies being dissected. One of them looks about like 9 inches long, has eyes, lips, and is struggling and looking around. And then they obviously terminate it right there. And Joe was saying, please don't air it. I'll be honest with you. I looked at it last night when Adan Salazar posted the latest video of it struggling, fighting before it's dissected, before the child is cut up alive. And I couldn't watch it. And then I was in a bad mood for the rest of the night. And I had my parents and family over for dinner. And I was in a bad mood. And they were like, why do you look so upset? I immediately, within about 30 minutes, got raging heartburn, which I never get. I had to take 2 Pepcid ACs, had so much acid in my stomach that I had to go back in the house when we were outside cooking and vomit, and then I couldn't even hardly eat dinner. There was nothing in my stomach but acid, because I hadn't eaten since lunch. But, I mean, I never get an upset stomach hardly. I have an ironclad stomach. And, you hear about cops that go to murder scenes and see dead kids, and the same thing happens to them. There are people on YouTube making jokes about the baby. So you know what? We're going to air the video. Coming up, probably when Dr. Grip's in here. And I'm going to watch the whole thing. Because you know what? I need to get sick. I need to throw up. I need to get physically upset. That's my soul saying, you got to fight this. What are you doing? Because out of that, you get real strength at the other side of it to do what needs to be done. And I tell you, the folks that are sneaking in and doing this, can you imagine their courage and their will to be around these demons for months, to get their trust and to sit there with a straight face while they're killing the babies? And I told you, they like to get them outside the womb. Under state and federal law, it is murder once they're outside the womb to chop them up. That's why they kill them and suck the brain out on a partial birth abortion, 7, 8, 9-month-old baby, with the head still inside the cervix. They open the cervix up big enough to get the whole head out. But the places that don't want to go to prison, because people gone to prison for this, they suck the brain out with a suction-powered large needle, huge gauge needle. It's like a vacuum cleaner, bigger than a turkey baster, to then implode the head. And then they check with a stethoscope to make sure the heart stopped before dissecting. Well, what I was told by insiders, we've had insiders on, insiders have blown the whistle, but footage was never gotten. Some clinics were shut down because of their testimony. The places that want to get top dollar, you need to keep the baby alive to dissect the organs and make sure that the tissue doesn't get damaged. So it takes a while to go in and cut them out properly and keep the arteries, you know, properly cut so they can be reattached to somebody else later. And I'm sorry I have to talk about all this. I don't want to. But it has to be talked about. And, of course, how bloody and filthy the facilities are. And a lot of the facilities get shut down because it turns out they are into the occult. They're doing weird stuff with the babies. I mean, who else do you think wants to sit around dissecting 7-month-old babies all day? I mean, you ever been to a preemie facility and you look at little sweet babies and your heart goes out to them? Well, that's mama that didn't want to lose the baby. We'll fight and do everything under heaven and earth to save a 6, 7-month-old preemie. But they'll dissect them all day long while they fight for their lives. And, of course, doctors that were abortionists have gone public. Some of the sonograms have been released where the baby will be fighting the scalpels, fighting the tongs. I mean, they fight for their lives in there. I mean, they'll be trying to, and that's just what happens. And the vets are going to fight for their lives when they have their treatment taken away. And you're going to fight for your life under global government care when they deny you care. You're going to work longer hours. You're going to live in a 100-foot apartment. Bloomberg has now announced they want 100-foot apartments. Luxury will be 250 square foot. They're going to take everything we've got. And I guess America's going to sit there and love it. But it makes me want to throw up. And you're not going to get one Black Lives Matter group funded by Hillary and Soros. Hillary's not clearly in control of it with Nancy Pelosi. You're not going to hear one word about all these arrogant, racist people, about all the blacks getting chopped up, getting murdered, getting taken out. You're not going to hear anything about it. 9-year-old girl shot dead in Ferguson. No riots, no protests because it was black on black. But more burning and attacks in St. Louis after a SWAT raid. The guy supposedly pulled a gun and they killed him. That's the media's mastery. Stir folks up on things that are like a 1 on a billion Richter scale. While babies are being chopped up fighting for their lives. All right, I digressed off into Adan Salazar's article about the latest video smuggled out of the baby organ harvesting factories where the women aren't told what's happening, where they're told just sign a bunch of forms. Horror, intact fetuses moves arms and legs outside womb in latest Planned Parenthood video. I'm looking at this fetus and its heart is beating and I don't know what to think. Those of you that are for abortion, go watch the video. And don't say that we're obscene showing this. Again, if you're a new listener driving along on the highway going, why does he keep saying, look at this? We are simulcast television. And I'm the first person in the internet age to simulcast a radio TV show. There have been TV shows that have been aired on the radio many times in that format. But this is radio style. Free flow, teleprompter free, in a professional million-dollar studio, basically. Because it adds another layer. You know, first with talk radio, when the internet came along, people could say, go to the site, look at this, and people could share the same photos, the same articles together there, starting in the early 90s, with the internet becoming more widespread. But now with television, you see almost every major radio show moving into this format. And that's just the natural evolution, but I am proud of the fact that I've been doing it since 1996, off and on, and then full-time for the last 12 years. But I digress. If you're a new listener, Infowars.com/show. When you hear me say, put it on screen or look at this graph, radio is the main audience, though, and sometimes we forget that. I myself, guest we have on, basically try to air videos that don't translate well on radio. So we always have to think about that in the main and understand that about 80% of this audience is AM and FM affiliates out there across the United States that are so essential that we support and promote and become sponsors of or support the sponsors of and let them know you're supporting the sponsors and tell everyone you know every day to tune in because the big power of this broadcast is in the major cities across this country where we're on the air, you're able to get huge amounts of people to tune in. And please keep doing that. It's having a giant, huge effect. And pray for those wonderful affiliates as well that are actually standing for the truth. You notice that more and more of this information is becoming mainstream. And that's because of the bravery of our affiliates, some of which we have affiliates in upstate New York and places in Tennessee, like WBCR in Knoxville and others, that have been carrying this broadcast for, I think, Tennessee, 16, 17 years. Upstate New York, Dr. Wolf stations up there. A great Jewish Christian American who died a few years ago, but his son runs it. We're on 3 affiliates in Rochester and Buffalo and other areas. We've been on there about 17, 18 years. Those are some of our oldest affiliates, but we have a lot of new affiliates across the country, and they're so important. I didn't mean to go off on a jag about that. It's just absolutely a key working part of everything we're doing here in the info war. In fact, it's the heart of it. So I want to thank those affiliates. And listeners are going out, joining with the stations, and paying for billboards for the show. That's happening across the country. But don't count on others to step up. Now is the time to put your money where your mouth is. We're going to lose everything if we don't put in a full effort. And here's the good news. In the bad news, the fact that things are so bad now and so naked and so out in the open with all the tyranny and the arrogance that people now are ready to wake up, if they ever will. Some people are deeper in denial. You can't reach them. But on average, people are the most receptive to the truth now they've ever been. And that's why they're pushing people like Donald Trump right now, whether he be good, bad, or a mix of the two, That's why he's so popular, and the more he's attacked, the more popular he gets, because when the mainstream media attacks you, that is the seal of approval. As I told Politico when Rand Paul got elected 4 or 5 years ago, they said, yeah, everybody came after him. He only got more popular, the dirty tricks. What's the secret? And I said, well, it's a populist libertarian system he's promoting, but more importantly, everyone demonized him in the establishment. And if you want to destroy Rand Paul, you've got to endorse his ideas, but then he wins anyways. So to bring down Rand Paul and eclipse him, into the vacuum comes Donald Trump. I just hope he's for real. We have a really important report from the Nightly News last night that I want to air, where David Knight breaks down some of the different angles to what Trump's really proposing. I wouldn't say it's an attack piece. It's a thoughtful piece, and I want to believe in Donald Trump, but we need to hold his feet to the fire, and we need to research what he's up to. That's coming up. Then the fall of Hillary appears to be completely imminent.
We're on the march.
Alex Jones here, back live. Thank you for joining us on this Thursday edition. I'm going to tape some special reports for tomorrow. David Knight will be hosting because I'm flying up to Toronto, Canada, to be part of an event George Norrie's putting on at the Queen Elizabeth II Theater there in Toronto. And then, of course, I may be back in time for the show. The plane's exactly on time Sunday. I'll probably end up co-hosting that with David, but we'll see. But I will also be shooting some reports from Toronto that we'll have for the Sunday radio show, 4 to 6 p.m. Central. But it's always informative. We have some big guests lined up for you tomorrow. And a lot of news we're going to be covering with David Knight. Speaking of David Knight, he did a report last night breaking down different angles of what Trump's policies would really do. And I already see Trump saying that, well, it's the right thing to do to deport all these illegals and to try to get rid of anchor baby status, but that he would accelerate bringing in people that actually have skills, have jobs, or who were here with good records. And that makes sense. You have to be deported. Then we can create a quicker pathway because you're not a felon. You had a job. You paid taxes. Let you come right back. I mean, every other country has very serious immigration laws. You can get into Mexico very easily, but you can't use any other services. And if they catch you coming in from Latin America, 6 months to a year hard labor in an open-air prison with mosquitoes biting you all day, something out of Devil's Island. Like a French penal colony. And that's even been in the New York Times that Mexico has some of the most draconian immigration laws in the world. Until a decade ago or so, you couldn't own land if you weren't a Mexican citizen. Well, why is Mexico allowed to have these rules and other countries? But we can't. I mean, we can't take on the whole world. The world's going into a massive depression. And then to make it worse, the illegals come in, they get put on the Democratic Party gravy train, get filled with liberation theology and racist hate the white people ideology, and that is what's going on. And it's a ticking time bomb. But here's Trump first in a New Hampshire event yesterday saying that he's not going to drop out. And this is good because he doesn't need to drop out. He doesn't need to run third party. Because he's a, quote, conservative mainly, that would put Hillary Clinton or, God forbid, Bernie Sanders in. And I'm not normally a lesser two evils person, but let me tell you, any of the Republicans but Jeb Bush would be better than Hillary Clinton or Bernie Sanders. I mean, I don't think Bernie Sanders is an inherently evil person, but he's never worked a day in his life. He is a demonic little stupid chipmunk. I mean, look at his senatorial photo. I mean, I don't usually go off looks, but I mean, Hillary looks like the Joker, acts like the Joker, and Sanders is this pie in the sky guy. The Walmart people have billions. What do we need to take it? Well, we need to understand Walmart has its employees subsidized, about half of them on welfare. Walmart does deals with China with slave goods. If he criticized Walmart along those lines, I'd say more power to him. Yes, the Walmart people got their money by changing the way retail sales work. There's something like 30% of retail sales in this country, something like 15% worldwide. And yes, they've helped deindustrialize this country. But that's Americans' actions Small Town America killed itself, committed Harry Carey with Walmart. So I don't blame the liquor companies when we got 100,000 people dying of liver failure a year. I blame people that are out of control. I don't blame gun manufacturers whenever their firearms are used to kill somebody. It's the person that did it. But in the case of Walmart, you can give them plenty of blame because they game the system. They're monopoly capitalist, not free market capitalist. But Americans put their head in the noose with Walmart. And now Walmart is closing in a lot of areas because the country's in a depression in many sectors. It's an unevenly distributed depression. Just like the future's here, it's just unevenly distributed. And that's what the future is all about, is diplomatic immunity above the law for the globalist, but the average person has absolutely no rights. So let's go to this Donald Trump clip.
Who do I see as strongest? You know, it changes from, the only thing constant is Trump. I mean, all of them change on the bottom. They're going up and down like yo-yos. But I've been up there for a long time, and I hope I'm going to be up there for a long time. You know, I read a lot of the phony reports, a couple of reports today in the paper saying, oh, well, you know, when Donald Trump gets tired of doing this, he's doing great, and he's leading all the polls. But at some point, he'll get, I'm not going anywhere, folks. I'm not doing this for my health. I'm doing this to make America great again. And again is a very important word. Very important word. I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere. Got a lot of money. I don't need people funding me like the other candidates. I have people coming up all the time wanting to give me millions of dollars. $5 million last week I turned down from one man. I said, I don't want your money. And I think that resonates with people. I really think it resonates with people.
We've time for one more question.
As if Donald Trump's interest won't become fabulously more rich if he gets into the presidency. Hillary Clinton went into the governor's house with her husband worth nothing. She was worth, what was it, $2 million? I remember covering it at the time whenever Clinton got elected president. Now, Hillary and Clinton, I saw the headline 2 days ago, made $140-plus million. Check my memory. Clinton's made over $100 million in the last year together. And that's with all their inside deals. I'm not saying Trump's doing that. But I noticed he said, what made America great again? And that's true. My memory was right. Clinton's earned nearly $141 million from 2007 to 2014. So it was over 7, 8 years, not a year. See, my memory fails. I read so much news. That's why I double check it. The crew takes everything I say, basically, puts it in the search engine and checks it. And I'm right about 95% of the time. I was wrong right there. Let's put it up. I'm sorry. They earned $141 million. In the last 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years. Of course, that's not counting their foundation that made hundreds and hundreds of millions as well, that they have their houses and helicopters and jets in. So if you add that together, it's way, way more than that. But it's been good for them. Good for them. You know, when they go to Japan and speak and get $1 million, what do you think that is? It's a payoff for stuff they did for Japan when they were president, because they were co-presidents, basically. And then now, she was at the State Department, gets money from dictators, but that's okay. The Clinton charity earned $2 billion since it was founded in 2011. $144 million in 2013 alone. And see, that's why I wanted them to pull that up. That's what my memory does. 10 years ago, it was almost photographic. It wouldn't have made that mistake. I flipped numbers now. I knew it was 140-something million in 1 year. That was the foundation. But that's constantly the mistake I make. I flip numbers that are in the same area and the same people. I'll get them mixed up in my memory. But that's why I have a crew to check everything I say. So, excuse me, it was 140-plus million in their foundation in a year and 140-something million in the last 8 years for them as personal profit. But, of course, like Bill Gates and all these other people, most of their money is in foundations that's tax-free. If you try to set something up like that, they come and arrest you, but they're allowed to operate like that. Now, we got big news coming up. I'm going to get back to Donald Trump here in a moment, but San Francisco earthquake, is this the big one? That's the London Telegraph, and that ties into this earthquake 4.2 that hit southern Colorado. I tell you, tectonically, the Ring of Fire is on fire, and it connects in from California and the West Coast into the central areas around Colorado, and we are due for some big activity. And a major earthquake hitting the West Coast that a lot of analysts think, if it makes the faults go in, could actually create an inland sea. If you look right there at where they think the earthquake may hit, you notice that fully falls in, the ocean would come in there. That's a seismic map, but notice where it's all centered. It would create a inlet up north of San Francisco that's already there and flood everything if the ground lowers. Talk about California falling off in the ocean, like Baja. That will cause a depression. Supervolcano goes off. By the way, they keep saying something giant's coming in September, and I've been hearing this for a year, and I kind of poo-pooed it. I mean, I'm not knocking Jewish mysticism and blood moons and all the rest of it, because historically, things have happened on those dates. But there's an article up on Infowars.com, the big list of 33 things that are going to happen in September 2015. Everybody keeps saying September 24th is the big date. And I would hear this about a year ago, and I'll be honest, I'd kind of roll my eyes. The Pope, though, didn't announce until a few months ago that that's when he's going to address the joint session of Congress. First time ever, a foreign head of state of a religious order lecturing Congress. But let's go to David Knight's report right now, looking at different angles of Donald Trump. Here it is.
Unlike every other campaign I've ever seen, from president to dog catcher, Trump has avoided putting up any issues, any policy statements about anything. He's been running on the strength of his character and his opposition to open borders. Now, for the first time, we see a detailed policy statement, and of course, it's on immigration. So let's take a look at the economic, the legal, and the liberty aspects of the Trump immigration policy. Bloomberg Business asks, what would happen to the economy if Trump got his way? Bloomberg says the supply of workers would shrink a lot. They also say service occupations would feel the burn. Illegal immigrants, they say, make up 5% of the workforce, and we don't have workers to replace them. Well, that's not true at all. This year, Americans out of the workforce rose to 33%, the highest rate since 1978. We all know from personal experience that entry-level jobs are being taken by immigrants, especially the jobs that typically went to students who were seeing depression-level unemployment rates. As these charts show, since December of 2007, the entire recovery that we've had since then, 75% of jobs have gone to foreign-born workers, and we have seen declining wages in America. The Bloomberg article also says that Social Security Fund would take a hit. They cite a study that undocumented workers pay $13 billion in payroll taxes. Do you really think that most illegals are paying Social Security taxes? One of the major incentives for American businesses to hire illegal aliens in the first place is that they can save over 7.5% in payroll taxes versus paying for a citizen who is on Social Security. And if they are paying the taxes, then the person who replaces them, who is an American citizen, would be paying those same Social Security taxes. Bloomberg, Wall Street, and the Washington politicians only look at the economic cost to businesses. But what about the welfare and education costs that anyone who pays taxes are being saddled with? Our borders are being flooded with foreign students. How is that going to be paid? With property taxes. It's not just the additional students. The costs per student are higher if they need special tutors. In Philadelphia, 800 students speaking 40 different languages from 70 countries have just been registered. If any child in the world can come here illegally and you can be compelled to pay for it, how will you be able to afford those soaring property taxes? Will you be put out of your home, or will you simply be impoverished? One excellent aspect of Trump's immigration paper is the H-1B visa abuse that he attacks. Reading from his statement, he says, increase the prevailing wage for H-1Bs. We graduate 2 times more Americans with STEM degrees each year than find STEM jobs. Yet as much as 2/3 of entry-level hiring for IT jobs is accomplished through the H-1B program. What are STEM jobs? Science, technology, engineering, manufacturing. The types of jobs that pay high wages that increase our standard of living. Let me repeat what he said. 50% of Americans with STEM degrees can't get jobs, yet 67% of entry-level IT jobs go to foreign workers with these H-1B visas. Let's turn to the legal aspects now, the anchor babies. That's been getting a lot of attention. The idea that foreigners could come to the U.S., have a baby, and then use that baby's citizenship to bring in an entire extended family, that is not something that you can find in the 14th Amendment. A lot of people have pushed back against the idea that we could ever stop the anchor baby program, but that's not in the text. The purpose of the 14th Amendment, remember, was to establish the rights of citizenship for freed slaves. Going back to the original passage of the 14th Amendment, in 1866, Senator Jacob Howard clearly spelled out the intent of the 14th Amendment. He said, every person born within the limits of the U.S. and subject to their jurisdiction is by virtue of natural law and national law a citizen of the United States. This will not, he writes, of course, include persons born in the United States who are foreigners, aliens, who belong to the families of ambassadors or foreign ministers accredited to the government of the United States. So it was never intended to make American citizens out of people who were born here of foreign parents who are visiting. That's what subject to the jurisdiction means. But even if you ignored that, why would you extend citizenship to the extended family? This is an abuse and it needs to be stopped. Trump is right to call for its end. Let's turn now to liberty and law enforcement issues. I agree with Donald Trump that we should stop this ridiculous catch and release program of criminals who are illegal aliens. Being here illegally should not give you legal immunity. You should not be treated like you're some kind of a foreign diplomatic ambassador. Trump calls for building a wall and making Mexico pay for it. He also calls for increasing the number of immigration and customs enforcement officers by 3 times. He points out that since September 11th, we've already increased the number of ICE officers by a factor of 3. So we're going to have 10 times the number of officers. We are creating a massive police state. We don't want to turn the American West into the West Bank of Israel with all of its oppressive population control measures. He also calls for nationwide e-verify. A new national ID card, an army of new law enforcement officers, and a gigantic wall around our country is not something that's going to stop immigration of people if you don't remove the subsidies and the incentives for them to come here. The flood of illegal immigrants is due to the incentives and the subsidies that we've created for the benefit of corporate profits and a socialist agenda. Stop those incentives and you can stop the flood of people. But creating a police state will do nothing to stop it if the incentives remain. For InfoWars, I'm David Knight.
We're going to skip this network break. David Knight has knocked it out of the park yet again. I thank God every day for the amazing reporters that we've been able to discover, like Joe Biggs, Ja'Kari Jackson, Leanne McAdoo, David Knight, our reporters, like Kit Daniels and Paul Watson, Adon Salazar, Mikel Thalen, just all the people. There's so many I can't mention everybody. It really is a brain trust of great people. And I think David's focused, smooth, researched approach is a nice mix to what I do and our guests do and what the other reporters do. It's a real blessing that he and his wife and family moved down here from North Carolina to be with us here in Austin, Texas. I want to get into Hillary Clinton and how much trouble she's in. I want to get into the big list of 33 things that are going to happen in September 2015. That's up on InfoWars.com. I want to cover the move now to 100 square foot apartments. Oh boy. Agenda 21 to run every facet of your life under zoning meant to basically end human freedom and privacy as we know it. They're announcing now that they're going to start passing laws in cities banning men's and women's bathrooms. And the word is the Austin City Council is going to be voting on that in the next few months. They're now writing it up. I talked to a city person I ran into today who's in zoning. I heard about it talking to a friend, and they said, yeah, no, that's coming up. Any new structures, businesses, you will not have men's and women's bathrooms. You will either go in and have one-person bathrooms, that's your choice now. They always give you a way to have a choice. That'll be phased out later. And then you will go in the bathroom with men and women together. Again, it's all about attacking any existing order and setting the precedent that you don't use the name boy or girl anything. This is so cultish. Oh, under the new zoning, we tax you extra if it's bigger than 500 square feet. That's about 6 years ago in New York. Oh, now it's 250 square feet. Oh, now it's 100. Yeah. Also, the big slumlords can rake you over the coals, and the government can charge you a bigger percentage of your paycheck, property taxes. Hope everybody likes it. No more fireplaces. No more gas-powered stoves. No more nothing when they're done. All starts with toilets and light bulbs. You watch the Green Police ad they had at the Super Bowl 5 years ago, and the firm that made it in San Francisco said, we worked with government with behavior placement to prepare the public for what's coming. And you watch. In fact, guys, will you pull up the Audi Green Police ad, please? Them arresting people because their hot tub is above 100 degrees. Arresting people because they have old-fashioned Edison bulbs. They're coming. They mean business. They harvest living children's organs. They run narcotics and fly your children they grab out of your backyard out on DynCorp aircraft. If you're a new listener and you hear that and you go, that's insane. You know I'd be sued if that wasn't true? Go look it up. You're nothing but meat at the grocery store to them. And they don't even pay for it. So man up, grow up, and realize you're under attack. Before we go any further, ladies and gentlemen, if you're not supporting this organization, if you're not supporting the info war, you're not involved in self-preservation. We are a hardcore organization, 110% dedicated to taking on the New World Order and exposing their operations. People can debate all day about who runs the New World Order. I'm going to focus on exposing that it's evil and it's bad and that it's universally attacking humanity. And we have silver bullet, colloidal silver, as you see all the diseases, all the things, the antibiotics not working anymore, whatever. I personally have had dramatic results topically and inside my body with 30 parts per million colloidal silver, recognized as the safest and best. Consult your physician before you use it, obviously. We have 30% off a single bottle while supplies last at InfoWarsLife.com or buy two. The regular price is already very low and get two free. You will not find high-quality colloidal silver made in the biggest, best lab in the country. You will not find it at this price anywhere, not for $19.95. Well, you buy two bottles and you get two free. That is an insanely low price. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. Supermel Vitality. You've heard the rave reviews. All I can say is it has improved my libido and that area of my life. Let's not exaggerate, 100%. I mean, I was never had any issues, but it's just unbelievable. Praise the Lord. Natural herbs, concentrated, better musculature, weight loss, dramatic energy. If I got to stay up or get to stay up and say do Coast to Coast AM or some of their big syndicated nighttime show, and I'm totally exhausted, I don't drink a bunch of coffee or beer like I used to. Beer actually is a stimulant for me. That's how I went from not even being a drinker to being a drinker. Because I would, you know, have some beer to stay up, you know, beer an hour or whatever. And I'd start smoking cigars and start smoking cigarettes. Just something to do, and you're up at 2 in the morning. Then I quit all that. But I just take some Super Mel Vitality now at like 6 or 7. Now, I don't do that if I want to go to sleep at 10 or 11. But if I'm staying up till 4 in the morning, I take 3 or 4 shots of Super Mel Vitality under the tongue, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. And Prostagard sold out in our first allotment. It is the most concentrated, hardcore, 10 ingredients. Known, palmetto, lycopene, plant sterols, zinc, vitamin D3, selenium, copper, and other key compounds known to be so good for the prostate and more. And it all just synergistically works together. Thank you all for your support. When you buy the products at InfoWarsLife.com, it makes everything we do here possible. InfoWarsHealth.com is the entire line discounted of longevity products that are excellent as well. the Beyond Tangy Tangerine 2.0, totally organic, the Pollen Burst, are all game changers. That's what I mainly recommend. They've just got hundreds of products, though. They simply are the highest quality. And when you purchase at InfoWarsHealth.com, it helps fund our operation. You can sign up and get 30% off when you sign up for $10, become a distributor. Or you can just buy directly or give them a call, 888-789-9277, 888-789-9277, InfoWarsHealth.com. Watch the informational videos and more. InfoWarsTeam.com is more focused on becoming a distributor for your store, your restaurant, your business, or just individually. But the Beyond Tangy Tangerine and Pollen Burst really helped me as well as a game changer. So that's available at InfoWarsHealth.com. All right, I'm done with the plugging. That's how we fund our operation. We do a lot less plugging than most radio hosts, as you know, plug as they come into a break, out of a break. I generally do it once an hour for 2 or 3 minutes and just get it over with. But that is how we fund ourselves, and they are game-changing products. InfoWarsStore.com has the entire family of high-quality shortwave radios, water filters, dash cams, block-it pocket-type stuff, books, films, apparel. It's all right there at InfoWarsStore.com. All right. Second hour straight ahead. Stay with us. Tell your friends and family. Tune in. You know, Dr. Edward Grip was in special operations in the Army. His dad was a famous chemist. He's a really informed political guy. So we're going to talk some about election 2016. What do you think of Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton, all of it coming up in the next segment. Then we're going to open the phones up for your herbal questions, your nutrition questions. He's not just a herbologist and a naturopath and a chiropractor. The guy's got like, I think it's 13, 14 different degrees. He's one of the top organic formulators in the country. That's why the herbal snobs love our stuff and give us such great reviews because, I mean, I went out and got the best people. I mean, I've been in Hollywood people's houses and seen his products 13, 14 years ago and didn't even know who he was and asked people, what is this? You know, what is oxy powder? What is, anyways, I'm not digressing off into that. We're going to get into politics with him, Hillary Clinton, some of the big victories we're having, and more. To show you how smart Larry Nichols is, nobody was saying this until today, that Larry Nichols, former top Clinton insider, was on a few days ago, and he said, Trump could be for real. Trump could be a shill. For Obama, because if you look, he's not really defending her, and he says they're at war because Hillary's kind of controlled him at first, and now Obama may want to stay in or may want to keep his people in government, even though he's going to leave, and the Clintons will put other folks in the bureaucracy than the Obama people, the appointees. They can appoint new people, and so they're double-crossing each other. It's now in the Washington Times. Why Obama is torpedoing Hillary Clinton. Because I'm not Machiavellian. I don't believe end justifies the means. But I can get in their shoes and look through their eyes and see what's going on. And we're just at such a critical juncture right now. The whole future of our planet is always being decided now. But, I mean, now more than ever, we're in a critical sector. But we mention this because they're now fining people and arresting people that throw away their light bulbs or don't use the right light bulbs or caught selling old toilets the wrong light bulbs. And they're fining people or whatever that, you know, try to build bigger houses or put a fence around their house. This is global. It's in 21. Now, inside New York City's infamous 100-square-foot apartments, they're now moving down from 250 down to 100. And that way they can tax you more. You don't save money doing this. Sure, it's less than a big apartment at first. Then over time, they phase it out. This is social engineering. Let's go to the Audi Green Police ad from a few years ago, which they admitted was social conditioning to prepare you for this. And now, this was 5, 6 years ago. Now it's happening. Here it is. Social envy showing rich people being SWAT teamed and then cops getting in trouble, too. It's all leftist perspective, and I said it was propaganda when it aired. Months later, they bragged in the San Francisco Chronicle that this is what they're going to do to us. This is real. They're not playing games. They're totalitarians. They've seized power. They kill children and sell their organs. They are devils. Well, my good friend, Dr. Edward Grubb, is visiting us up here in Austin, Texas from Houston. And we're going to cover the waterfront in this hour. We're going to open the phones up starting in the next segment for your questions on the latest health news, on nutrition, on detoxing with Dr. Edward Grubb. I'm Alex Jones, your host. Then Tosh Plumley is going to be joining us coming up in the third hour, the famous CIA contractor that just retired 2 years ago, who blew Benghazi wide open 2 years ago on this broadcast. He's got new information and a challenge towards Hillary Clinton. We could be seeing the end of Hillary, as I said Sunday. I gave about an 85-90% chance that she's going to have to get out of the race. Now you've got mainline Democrats coming out saying that. And the Washington Times has an excellent article up on Infowars.com. Why Obama is torpedoing Hillary Clinton. So that's all coming up as well. Now, speaking of torpedoing, the economy from China to Europe is clearly in free fall. And you've got the Pope coming to speak the 24th of September. You've got CERN firing up to do some of its most dangerous experiments ever, the superconducting supercollider or mega cyclotron that's in multiple states of France and Switzerland. It's so big. And even mainline scientists say it could create a black hole that starts sucking matter in and sucks the planet in. It could create a strange lip that sinks to the center of the planet and implodes it. It could do all this, but the probability is low. Well, maybe that's true. But mathematicians, respected ones, physicists, they've warned of it. You tie all this together, it just shows the hubris, just like when they wanted to see if high-powered hydrogen bombs detonated in the upper atmosphere would destroy the atmosphere or ignite the atmosphere. And they thought it might happen, so they went ahead and did it. That's covered in the documentary I talk a lot about, just because it's well done, with William Shatner, Trinity and Beyond, on Discovery Channel. It came out like, you know, 1999 or whatever. It just shows, like, genetic engineering, any of it. The whole world's a giant experiment now. And used to, they'd, you know, put moms on some drug to calm them down, and it would, you know, they'd have babies with no arms and legs. But that's just babies with no arms and legs. That's bad. That's a problem. Now we're doing experiments with the whole planet that could end the world as we know it. So I want to get Dr. Grubb's take on that, the election, and more. But he came in here and raised this point. He goes, everybody's bringing up the middle to late part of September. And there's an article on Infowars.com, the big list of 33 things that are going to happen September 2015. And September 2015 going to be the month that changes history. You've got economic alignments, top analysts saying implosion, acceleration, moving tanks and weapons in against the Russians, kicking off in September. You've got ISIS launching larger offensives. You've got North Korea suddenly firing across today at the South. North and South Korea exchanging artillery fire. And mines have been killing South Korean soldiers. Major escalations there. I'm not saying anything's going to happen big in September, but I remember actually a couple years ago hearing the last blood moon comes in the middle of September and then all hell breaks loose and Jewish mysticism. And I'm like, okay, I'm not poo-pooing all that. I'm not disrespecting it, but come on. And I didn't, you know, believe it. And I'm not saying it's going to happen now, but you go over all the things happening. The elites believe in this. Like the Romans used to go to war when Mars was in a certain aspect of vengeance or whatever, when they thought the stars were ready. And the elites today, most presidents, prime ministers, they operate on astrology and all this. So they believe in it. Whether you and I believe in it or not, it's going on. And now it's all coming to a head in the real world. It's just weird that, like, 2 years ago, talk about the blood moons in September of 2015. Talk about the last blood moon. Talk about the... I'm just like, okay, go take your Thorazine. And then now it just looks really weird. And in the last 6 months, last year, everybody I talked to does have this sense of this ominous or this portend, this feeling of unease, of the edge of your seat, of excitement building and building and building and building. And now I've gone past the dread point to almost like the hair on fire. exhilaration of the changes, good and bad, is rising at the same time, a key point in human history, and the elites know it. They're accelerating everything. So, Dr. Group, I've spoken for 4 minutes prefacing this. What do you think's going on? What do you want to add to the mix here?
I don't really know exactly what's going on, but I've been getting a lot of emails lately with people that are on YouTube that are putting all these pieces together. You have financial collapse situation. You have the Pope coming in to meet in September. You have Jade Helm ending in September. What I'm concerned about is, or the research that I've looked at from all these sources that give you information and give me information, is the CERN Switzerland project, which is the 17-mile circle that's buried 300 feet under the ground, which is a large hadron collider. And the research that they've been doing on that is basically to create a portal, and they're going to be firing that thing up in September. I was just
They admit shocked. They want to break into other dimensions.
Because I'm like you, it's just like, you know, you hear about the end of the world, Y2K, and this and this here and this here, but the information that I've been getting and looking at, because I always keep an open mind to everything and try to evaluate everything, but I'm telling you, from all the movies that have been coming out, Tomorrowland actually has a section in it on the trailer that says 923. Everything is, the Lego is coming out with a dimensional portal set later in September. The reactor is going to be fired up in September. They don't even know. It's like creating the God particle. We're like trying to play God now.
That's what they call it.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, what they're doing is they're colliding particles at faster than the speed of light to create a big bang. They're trying to figure out, go back in time and say what happened with the universe.
Well, we just put a mainline news article up where they admit that they've already done small tests. Now they're doing the big one with more power. They admit, oh, we've already created antimatter. How wonderful. Well, if there's a chain reaction, bye-bye. And of course, when you see like the last Star Trek movie before the last one, two Star Treks back, they admitted that they actually got that from the scientist of what a black hole forming on the Earth would look like, or a strangelet where the whole planet gets attacked and by a mining ship that basically does the same thing CERN does, and it crushes the planet. That's what it would actually look like if they do this. And we're not saying this is going to happen. The point is they're doing tests where they admit it could destroy the planet.
1 gram of antimatter, which is what they're trying to create, is the equivalent of 4 atomic bombs. I mean, it's absurd to think that we would even be trying to carry on an experiment like that. And every one of the scientists said there could be dangers involved with it. But we don't know what's going to happen until we fire it up.
Well, I don't know if Atlantis really happened, but this is really happening.
This is really happening, and it's not in the news. And it's, again, it's just one of those things. It seems like everything that you look at, Yom Kippur, is happening in September. You look at all the different things that are revolving around September. I cannot remember a time that so many things point to September. And again, I mean, we're not fear-mongering and saying something's going to happen in September, but there is a lot of things.
Everybody else is saying it. This is where I'm actually on the tail end of this. We're not the progenitors of this.
Exactly.
People are freaking out about it.
Yeah, exactly.
And then you look, there's a lot of stuff going on.
Right.
And just the economic front.
Just the economic front. Look at the controversy right now with what happened with the explosion in China. I mean, you know, that's a whole nother subject with the economic collapse that's happening. Who knows what's going to happen? But the main thing with me is let's try to protect the population as much as possible. Let's try to help as many people as we can get prepared. You know, it's always good to have a warning, not to create fear and stress and bring your immune system down, but at least know that, hey, if something happens, I have what I need to survive, or I have, you know, an area that I can go that I can get clean.
Well, sure. And by exposing this, being concerned, we don't have nuclear war in the Cuban Missile Crisis. We don't have a war with Russia. We don't have ISIS break out into more countries. By talking about the problems, we force it out in the open so that a solution can be carried out. Like it'll cost $2-3 billion to harden all of the U.S. Electrical systems. So there's a Carrington event or an EMP. We're not back in the Stone Age. The Pentagon and Congress admit 90% of America would die within 1 year if a Carrington event blew out a lot of the power.
Right.
And I mean, EMP. It took us this long to build this infrastructure. We're very precarious, just in time delivery. There's just a little example of real insurance we should have.
They actually did studies. It's not funny, but they did studies on what would happen in the case of an EMP. And you basically, everybody's not going to understand what happened, the majority of people out there. If you see cars all of a sudden dead on the road, you better just start getting outside of a big city as fast as you can. Because after 24 hours, the food starts to spoil. People still don't know what's going on. But you have about 72 hours. After that, All hell breaks loose because there's no food. There's no water.
And in every study, unless they're talking about Japanese, it's just a fact, people then start burning everything down. And then within 10 days, almost anyone will murder others. Within 15 days, almost universal cannibalism.
You also have the crossing now, and this is actually NASA documents that say that there's meteors that are going to be crossing in September too.
Well, we're already entering bunch of them. That's why there's so many big showers.
Right. That's right. And it's funny. It's not funny, but about 6 years ago, I was contacted by what was supposedly a top secret organization that was put together by the government to try to find the best method to deter a meteor shower.
By the way, that project's now admitted.
That's right. But I'll tell you about what happened with that project after the break.
Well, I don't want to get anybody in trouble, but the point is, there's a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes. We'll be right back. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. Your questions for Dr. Grew. And it can be on anything, but mainly health stuff. 800-259-9231. I'm Alex Jones. Stay with us. Welcome back. It's Alex Jones here with Dr. Group. This is a short segment. I'll go to your calls at the start of the next segment. Jeff, Brad, Adam, Andrew, Thomas, and many others that are calling in. Up on Infowars.com, Trump's immigration policy, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Very important article, very important video. We just aired it in the last hour. Be sure and get that out to everybody so they can understand what's really happening there. Another headline might be the 14th Amendment does not allow anchor babies. In fact, it outlaws them, and we have the proof. So really, you can say that about the report. Proof that the 14th Amendment outlaws anchor babies. They're using it as the way to legitimize it. Innocent couple investigated for child abuse after social worker makes bogus CPS call. MLK's niece slams Black Lives Matter protesters on this show yesterday. Watson's written an article about it. D's nuts, that's not a joke, more popular than some of the major candidates like Huckabee, Walker, and others. 9-year-old girl shot dead in Ferguson. No riots, no protest, because it was black on black. And then the cops nearby in St. Louis, in the same state, raid a house. The guy pulls a gun, reportedly shoots him. Now there's more riots and burning. I mean, it just shows what the White House and George Soros are able to do. Another important report by John Bowne, if we move the camera over a little bit for TV viewers, the truth about ISIS. Here's how they screw you over at the gas pump. Another great report showing you how some of the scams that are out there and more. Donald Trump still rising in the polls. So in this short segment, let's cover the waterfront here. What do you think of Hillary? I smell her political blood in the air. Fee, fi, fo, fum. I smell the blood of a witch going down. I think this probably is it. She may last 6 months. She may get pardoned, but I think her political career is over. What do you think? I want to get your take, though, if you disagree on that. What do you think about, have you seen the new video of the little baby that's alive, fighting for its life, and then being dissected, that's on Infowars.com? What do you think of this whole Planned Parenthood situation?
Well, I agree. I think Hillary's on her way out. It just amazes me that she has, well, I know the numbers are, skewed anyway, but it amazes me that she's supposedly has 38% of the presidential race poll. I mean, I don't see how that could possibly be. It doesn't take but maybe 10 minutes of research online to learn about the past of that scenario. As far as Planned Parenthood, I think that's sick. I mean, that video is, atrocious. That goes back to the Bill Gates family with the connections to Planned Parenthood that ties into the population control agenda. And for them to be able to sell fetuses and take video of a fetus coming out with the heart still beating and dissecting, I mean.
Well, I said I'd play it again, and I I cannot bring myself. It's like when you jump off a 100-foot bridge and you're scared. It's worse than that. I cannot bring myself to order them to play it, because if I play it, I'm going to watch it again, and I only watched part of it and literally had so much acid produced that I started vomiting last night.
It's
I never do that. I've seen people dead on the side of the highway and didn't get sick. But it's just, it's the realization that they're doing it, they're getting away with it, none of us are safe. I mean, it's the realization that we're dealing with literal demons.
Yeah, I was just up in Canada, and I was at a little statue thing over there, and there was a group of autistic children that were there playing, and it was, you know, it's sad to watch these 20 children that they just really don't even know where they are. And you know, it's
they like were soft killed.
It's like the video. It's there's soft killing. You just, it almost, it, you get so emotional about it.
It's like seeing troops have had their arms and legs blown off, but it wasn't done by a foreign enemy to a man. You realize this is the globalist. This is their little gift to us.
Right. And the damage done. I mean, think of the parents that have to go through
this. And the fact that they can cover it up.
Right. The fact that they can just cover it up and act and say that the vaccines didn't cause the condition.
And soon it'll be 1 out of 3 within 10 years, the CDC admits. And then it'll be, it's no big deal. Let's have a race to raise money for their diapers. No one wants to find out why it's happening. We're being murdered. It's all us. We're living in a science fiction movie, brother.
Yeah, the slow death is even worse. I mean, it's just so hard to see these children suffer, and the moms and all the psychiatric medications that they're feeding them, and the vaccines and the genetically modified foods and the all the chemicals in the air and the water. I mean, it's a slow attack, a manipulation from the time. Well, even we've been suppressing births. I mean, that's why it's so hard for people to even get pregnant these days.
In the West.
In the West.
The chemicals.
All the chemicals. So, and we haven't even seen what's going to happen 7 generations, 2 or 3 or 4 generations down the road, where it's supposed to be even worse.
We're going to come back. I'm going to briefly ask you about North Korea, because I know in your military service, you were in a lot of secret operations there when things were heating up as well. We've had North and South Korea exchanging artillery fire and gunfire and people getting killed by landmines the last 2 days. South Korea fired tens of artillery rounds towards North Korea on Thursday after North Korea launched shells to protest. We'll be back. But now under globalist social engineering and genetic engineering, we are seeing the destruction of our very DNA. We are seeing the very destruction of not just our species, but the heart of the ecosystems of this planet. We are seeing a genetic vandalism, splicing plants with animals, insects with animals. It is over-the-top evil. And then the very groups that are pushing all this stand up on their high horses and say, world government, carbon taxes on all human activity, 100 square foot apartments now, no single family dwellings, families are bad, no boys and girls. I mean, they're ending the species. Chemicals in the water to lower fertility. Writing books about it. The White House science czar. And then the public just can't believe the horror and has been stunned and mesmerized by television. But I do see humanity trying to shake themselves out of it. Adan Salazar came up to me during the break. He wrote the article that went viral. Horror, intact fetus moves arms, legs outside womb, in latest Planned Parenthood video. They had it up on screen in there, and they put it out on Facebook with a GIF that shows the baby struggling. And I was in there just trying to not look at it. And Adan said, you know, I got nauseous and basically threw up yesterday as well. And he said, I just suddenly felt sick 30 minutes later. It like hits your subconscious. In fact, I can't look at it anymore. Put it down. And I understand why folks don't want to look at this. And I know why you get mad at me putting it out. But it needs to be there and at least looked at one time. And people that are for this need to see it as well. I mean, if I see a little baby bird struggling and dying, and I know it's got mites all over it and fire ants all over it, I'll step on its head. And one time I had a girlfriend in high school, and there was a bird dying at the park with fire ants on it. And I said, oh, that bird's in pain. I'm going to kill it. And she's like, she got mad at me after I stepped on its head. And I said, baby, I care about that bird. It's dead already. Look, the fire ants had basically eaten its eyes out. It's in hell. I killed it for a good reason. It's like, you know, she kept getting mad. It was the emotion. I said, you know how they shoot horses that break their legs because you can't really fix those because the horse won't stay in a cast? I said, it's the same thing. They don't shoot the horses because they don't care about them. Well, if you can't look at this baby, folks, you shouldn't be able to look yourself in the eye ever again. I've looked at it. It's torn me up. You need to look at it. And other people need to look at it. So they're going to put the article back out with some updates and this GIF that's gone viral for folks to share. We're going to leave the original article up with the headline group. And I want you to help me come up with a headline. What is it? Baby fights for its life after being aborted? Or baby fights for its life before having organs harvested? And then we explain out of a science fiction nightmare movie beyond anything we could ever imagine, the fully developed child struggles and fights for its life with heart beating on a stainless steel table. I mean, this is the reality. It's what they don't want you to see it. They got 3D ultrasound banned by non-medical doctors because clinics were doing it because people wanted photos of their kids. But people were stopping who were pregnant, who were going to get an abortion, and seeing it was a human and weren't wanting to do it. This is a classic example of them trying to keep us in the dark. What headline should we run with and repost this?
I like the ones that you came up with. I mean, really help stop the slaughtering and sale of living fetuses, black market. I mean, something like that. I don't know, but it's...
I mean, that's it. Baby fights for its life at organ harvesting facility.
Yeah, that's true. Every one of those headlines is true. I mean, it's... Oh, my gosh, it's...
I'll tell another really gross story. One time with my uncle, who died last year, lived out in Fredericksburg, and we were driving down the road next to his little ranch, and we saw a deer for a few days that had been tied up, you know, had run and jumped and got caught in a cattle fence, and they'll struggle and get wound up. Mm-hmm. And it was next to dead, eyes had been gobbled out by birds, but it was still alive. And I pulled out an AK-47 and shot it and then pulled it out of the fence. And I didn't enjoy killing the deer. I mean, but it did at a genetic level. Felt good to put it out of its pain. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, you know, the suffering, that's what we were talking about earlier. It's the long-term suffering, and I see this with cancer patients year after year. They're suffering and suffering. Diabetes, they suffer, then they lose their leg because of ulcers. Arthritis, they can't walk. I mean, we have a society right now that treats degenerative disease. So people suffer. How many people do you know over the age of 40 that don't have some condition they suffer from? Whether it's obesity, whether it's a joint pain, headaches, cancer, diabetes, heart disease, on multiple medications.
All going up.
It's a long-term suffering. That's exactly what's happening in America today.
It's a soft kill. And I tend to start telling stories or analogies and never finishing them. That's how my brain works. But these are children that didn't need to be suffering and be tortured. I was just using the example of the empathy I have when I see an animal struggling and hating seeing it, so I put it out of its misery. Well, I didn't make the deer jump in the fence, or I didn't make the baby bird have fire ants go up in the tree and get it. And, you know, it falls out of the tree. With this, you can't deal with it because it's being done by these ghouls who want to keep people in the dark. But I do think it's the helplessness and the struggling of the little baby. And you realize what bullies these people are, what lying bullies. And you want to protect that child. And not because I'm Mr. Goody Two Shoes or Knight in Shining Armor. It's at a genetic level. Seeing the young of our species being pissed on, excuse my French, being devalued, being debased, being executed, being tortured. And they didn't do anything. And watching all these people that call themselves liberals smack their lips and tell me how they're moral and high and mighty when I know secretly they're a bunch of Heil Hitler Nazis. Go ahead.
Well, you know, that's why we're trying to get out the good solutions to stop this abuse and to stop this attack and let people know that you do have the ability to heal yourself. You do have the ability to reactivate your own self-healing mechanism. You don't have to suffer anymore. We can put a stop to all this if people stand up, and people already are standing up. People are becoming more educated, looking at the positive side of things. People are taking advantage of the technology that's out there to improve their own health. They are waking up and realizing that they're going down the stairs of health one step at a time, and they can turn themselves around. They they can get results and start seeing results in their body.
Exactly. We're not just about telling you the bad, so you're aware of it. That's important. But about taking action. I want to go to phone calls, but briefly. South Korea, this is one of the biggest blow-ups they've ever had since the demilitarized zone was set up. You were in Army Special Operations. You said most of the actual adventure you had and action you had from being a lot of places in Europe and other places was in Korea there on the demilitarized zone. What's your take on the latest developments?
Well, I was sent over there for the 1988 Olympics because North Korea was banned from the Olympics that year. And I can tell you the North Koreans back then used a lot of psychological warfare. They had a whole city set up right there on the border, on the DMZ, and they would play blare music.
They're doing that again.
Sounds all night long to try to use psychological warfare on us. Our unit never was involved in any firefights, but the South Korean unit that was special operations was ahead of us on the border, and they were involved in firefights practically every night. We were there to back them up in case something happened. So, there's always been tension between North and South Korea. It doesn't surprise me that it's finally escalating as we're starting to see different things escalate all over the world right now, especially with military powers. So we'll see what happens with that.
It just seems like hell's breaking loose everywhere.
Yeah, that's what it seems like.
We're going to go to your phone calls. Thank you for holding. Jeff in Tennessee, thank you for calling in today. You're on the air.
Hey, Alex, Dr. Group. Great to talk to you guys. Just had a couple questions on nutrition. I've actually got a thought on Trump, but I'm more interested in nutrition. With the economy and everything as great as it is, my pay has been cut. I don't have as much money to buy supplements that I used to have. Just a couple things that I'm doing. I'm 37 years old. Drink apple cider vinegar, a couple tablespoons mixed in a quart of water. Been taking the Brain Force, which the only thing I can say about Brain Force that I can really tell it does is when the stress is on, mentally I'm very steady. I can definitely tell it's a very... It keeps my mind very focused and very steady.
Well, exactly. We put it out not to make you jittery. We put it out with stuff that's really just components of the brain. And Dr. Group didn't formulate this, but he was just talking with me off air about what a good formula it is. We went to one of the biggest top manufacturers and said, we want to put out your dream product because other companies don't want to put something out expensive. That is for the producer. I mean, this really has expensive ingredients in it for a low price comparatively. But that's why there's not even more caplets in there, because it is so expensive for us. So much of the cost really is the cost of the products. Why do you think Brain Force creates that steadying focus? That's one reason I've been still upset and yelling a lot. But people said, why is he so calm? Why is he so more focused a lot of the time? And it is the Brain Force.
Well, I'll tell you the reason why most people need brain supplements is because of the heavy metals and the aluminum and the geoengineering that's going on, obviously. They also need vitamin D, which is very important. So I don't know if you're on that, but I would definitely recommend the winter sun. What's happening with all this geoengineering and the chemtrails is it's designed to block the UVB rays, and so your own body can create vitamin D. So from what you've said so far, Jeff, you're doing really good on a limited budget, taking the things that you need. Ultimately, with drinking extra water, believe it or not, actually, stress is one of the things that causes a lot of health problems to exacerbate.
So much as breathing, that's free.
Meditation is free.
Exercising, but I mean, we don't sell it. We promote Bragg. You believe it's the best? I do too. Apple cider vinegar just daily is the game changer.
Well, everything's going towards gut health. And that's why the Oxy powder is so effective. It helps heal the gut. Probiotics are the new thing that everybody needs to be talking about, because everything really starts in the gut and the liver. And also making sure that your liver is clean. You have the Liver Shield here, which is an incredible product that people can take to clean the liver every now and then, let the liver function again, because the liver is what really handles all the chemicals and the toxins and detoxifies them from your system. So if you heal the gut, heal the liver, reduce your stress, you're making serious strides to perfect health. And that's why people are, you can drink kombucha tea, the fermented foods, getting those good probiotics.
It's just a lifestyle change. Don't eat processed foods. Don't eat GMO. Drink a lot of water, get more exercise. And again, I'm not Mr. Beach Boy, but compared in the photos we put out, to myself 10 years ago and now, I mean, I've lost 60 plus pounds of fat. And I mean, when I'm in a bathing suit, people can really see it. Maybe we can dig up the photos. I didn't plan to plug this stuff, but I mean, it's a massive difference. Anything else, Jeff?
Well, I was also going to say that I take the Tangy Tangerine. I can definitely tell that that's a really good product. The vitamin D, you think that's a pretty good, that would be something good to add to what, you know, those things that I'm doing?
Well, what I've read from chemists and medical doctors and everybody is vitamin D really is a building block of everything, isn't it, Group?
Vitamin D and iodine are pretty much the building blocks that we've seen. Also, people are deficient in B as well. That's why we have the Secret 12. But I take vitamin B, I take the vitamin D, and I take the iodine on either a daily or every other day, at least a few times a week. Those are essential that you're going to need to function, that there's receptor sites for every cell in the body. And I think that it's about uncovering the agenda too. And when you see and you look up and you look at, okay, why are they doing geoengineering? Or why are they taking iodine?
Thank you, caller. Thank you, Jeff.
Then you realize that it's a combination of things. Why are they putting all the phthalates and all the BPA and all the plastic?
By the way, you go and look at what they're doing to public school children in the 6th and 7th grade when they know they're not questioning. 5th, 6th, 7th. It was probably 10 years ago. We've dug it back up before. If anybody's got it, resend it to us. It was on the Prison Planet forums, how I found out about it. And then the listener mailed me the textbook. So it's somewhere around this giant office area and back there in storage. The mainline national, one of the most popular science textbooks used for sixth graders in the United States. This was sent to us from Kansas City, a KCXL listener, still on that fine affiliate. And I'll never forget, I mean, I covered it for weeks. It was in there telling the kids, yes, we added to the jet fuel, barium sulfum dioxide, to block the UV rays. It's going to give you cancer. And it's to stop global warming, and it's a project. So the textbook, government approved, admits it, then they tell us it doesn't exist, but we can go out and find the government funding for the program. I mean, there's just so much incredible secret stuff going on, is what I'm getting at, and then they'll sit right there. I remember Time Magazine for Kids, again, about 12 years ago, a listener mailed in, it was Time Magazine for Kids, and it said, your parents are from a bygone age. They don't know what they're doing. You're smart. You're going to take chips under the skin. You understand. And it was written like satire to an adult, that it was just naked propaganda. But that's targeting a sixth grader. Again, like, you're rebelling against your parents. You're going to get a chip. Knowing that when they're then 20, and then the chip comes out, which is now happening, they'll be subconsciously, subliminally at that point, when something's that old, it's subliminal, conditioned to accept taking the microchip. That's how cold-blooded. I mean, it's so systematic, Dr. Group.
That's why they come out with all the movies, too, and all the cartoons and everything else to start at an early age to, you know, condition the minds. I mean, but on the positive note of that, that's why you figure out, okay, what's going on with geoengineering? I look at it as, how is that affecting everybody's health? Okay, it's blocking the UVB rays. It's going to suppress vitamin D production. Every cell needs vitamin D. That must mean that there's an agenda to block vitamin D, and that's exactly what's going on, because you can even trace that agenda back to the creation of sunscreen.
I meant to cover this for 2 weeks. I forget what they're called, but I was on the elliptical 2 weeks ago in Europe, and I thought I was looking at a science fiction movie. It looked bizarre, of these lakes in California where they put like 6 million plastic spheres in it, and it reduces something like 300% the amount of evaporation. That's an example of a mass geoengineering program. And maybe during the break we can show some footage of that, but that's what these globalists are into. They're terraforming the planet right now, but to some new weird freaky design with aluminum in the soil that plants can't grow in. I mean, it is just crazy that all of this is happening and that all of this is unfolding. We'll be right back. Stay with us. Dr. Group's my guest. More calls straight ahead. Dr. Group is an amazing individual, good friend of mine. We hang out, my wife and he and family, whenever he comes to town, his wife. And he gets me so excited, the topics he brings up, that I constantly interrupt. It's very rude. I apologize for it. I've gotten better overall, but we get into science discussions. I start hyperventilating. We're going to hold him 15 minutes to the next hour and then get Tosh Plumlee on with his breaking news on Benghazi so that he has time to take your calls. Because I'm always trying to get him in on topics. He goes, yeah, I want to come into Austin, but I want to talk to your listeners, you know, about their questions. So we're going to go to your phone calls. But on the shade ball issue, they're putting 300 million. They're saying that these can save 300 million gallons of water annually at one Los Angeles reservoir alone. And they're putting millions of the shade balls into the lake. And when we show this video, I'm sure you've all seen it already. It's been out for weeks. The entire lake is covered with the black balls. And I just wonder what type of VOCs, what type of bisphenols it's putting in the water. Now, it's supposed to stop this algae that is linked to cancer. Okay, great. But this is an example of geoengineering. When you talk about chemtrails, the layman parochial term, there is a giant quasi-secret program going on that the Arabs, like in Dubai, admits going on. So just like harvesting babies' organs is being kept secret, you need to understand, folks, it's only quasi-secret. It's only secret enough on the surface to have you not investigate it. The Department of Energy admits they spend $5 billion a year in geoengineering testing. That's in close quotes, because under U.S. Code Title 30, Chapter 32, Section 1528, Paragraph B, any testing is legal as long as it's for research, including lethal. That's key. Go read it for yourself. U.S. Code Title 50, Chapter 32, and the other subsections I mentioned. It says it's all illegal unless for research purposes. So what we know about is so fantastical it makes my head spin. Dr. Group, we're going to go to break, come back and take calls. But what else do you think is going on we don't know about if what we already know is beyond science fiction?
Well, there's one thing that I know, and that's to focus on the figuring out the solutions for each individual thing. And, you know that you have bad air that you're breathing. So there's solutions to cleaning up the air quality by putting live plants in your home, increasing the oxygen, getting a good air purification system. We know the water's bad, so we can just make sure that we drink clean water with organic apple cider vinegar added to get the nutrients and the probiotics and the enzymes. We know we can take a vitamin D supplement to combat the geoengineering scenario with the UVB rays, and that's going to protect all of our cells. We know that we can take iodine to combat and decalcify the pineal gland and get rid of all the fluoride and the chlorine and the bromine that is toxic and that they're exposing us to on a regular basis. We know we need to clean our intestines on a regular basis and put good probiotics in. So it's really about, yes, we are being bombarded. There are trails of these things going deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper.
Could you imagine being able to have the top globalist master plan and they admit they have these and actually see what the end game is? I mean, we already see a lot of it. A reduced population, robots, a new engineered planet, with all these splice species, it sounds like something the devil would do.
I don't think anybody that is good would be doing this, that's for sure. I mean, there is a lot of negative and a lot of evil.
Also super dangerous.
It's extremely, I mean, what we're seeing is a sick and diseased planet, a sick and diseased universe, sick and diseased animals, sick and diseased humans. Everything is sick and diseased.
And they're not trying to stop entropy, they're trying to accelerate it.
That's right. I mean, but more and more people are figuring it out, and there are solutions to it. You have to learn how to live with it. You have to learn how to combat it. You have to learn how to prevent it from affecting you and your family.
Mentally, you know, I could write a science fiction book where aliens run the planet, and this is all like a big test to like create the superhumans that are going to survive what comes out of this. And the ultimate prison planet, you know, that would make the prison planet from Dune look like a heavenly place. Guys, let's roll the footage of the millions of black balls that they're dumping in to L.A. Reservoir. And I saw this a few weeks ago. I meant to cover it. It's an example of geoengineering. We need the hashtag black balls matter, because they do. We were talking earlier, and Dr. Group said that's the worst color ever, black. It's going to make bacteria grow under it. It's going to heat the water up and cause more of it to go into the air. They claim it's to stop bacteria and algae. Again, I'm no rocket scientist, but algae grows under stuff like that. Maybe if they totally cover it, they're right and I'm wrong. But even Fox News, Nico just ran in with this and said, L.A. Black Ball Reservoir rollout, potential disaster in the making, say other experts. And they say that the $34.5 million tiny black plastic balls. They're pretty big balls. Like, anyways, the point is, like the baseball size, a little bit smaller, are saying it'll actually grow bacteria and heat up the water. Same thing we said. We're not, I guess you're a scientist. I mean, any idiot could say, why do they make the balls white? That'll reflect the light back up.
Why don't
a reflector's
just...
white, it ain't black. Black absorbs.
Right. The worst thing you can do is start messing with nature. What you need to start doing is supporting nature. Plant more
But trees. I mean, we're not rocket scientists. Why aren't the balls white
because
or silver?
You don't even need balls in there. All you need to do is just look at other solutions, planting more trees.
Do black balls matter?
That was a setup. I'm not even going to answer that. Hashtag black balls.
Hey, Richard came up with it in my ear just now. People always think somebody's telling me what to say, and they do. No, they pop in occasionally. Sorry. Yeah, the guy that's like one of the front runners in the campaign isn't even real. Did you hear about those names?
Yeah,
I'm not trying to be a comedy show.
He's got 9% of the votes or whatever.
Yeah, D's nuts, yeah.
Yeah, D's nuts. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I ask them. Anyway, let's... If it's okay,
we apologize.
Let's take some calls.
We're going to calls. I apologize. I'm evil. Brad in Louisiana, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Alex, that was so funny, man. You can tell that you guys are good friends, and I really appreciate it. I refer to you as the dynamic duo. I have a question for Dr. Group, and I have a comment for you, sir.
Sure, brother. Go ahead.
First of all, okay, good. There is an agenda underway, as you regularly state, and depopulation, and with regard to at least putting the population growth into remission. And so I asked Dr. Group, what does he feel is the purpose behind the introduction of dietary supplements such as this nicotinamide riboside, which involves the dealing with a yeast cell, manipulation of the DNA there, and advertising it as weight reduction, anti-aging, and libido enhancement, cardiovascular health, etc. Why are they doing this when we know that that's exactly the opposite of what they intend for us?
Well, the globalists will always sell you the solution, at least a treatment to the problem they've helped create. I don't know what company you're talking about. They may be great. I'm not a chemist or expert like folks that Dr. Group works with. But Dr. Group, do you know what he's talking about?
There's always some sort of, even though they make it look good out here in the marketing and everything, there's always some ulterior motive that you have to look at. And it might be as simple as some sort of a filler ingredient that they're putting in there. It all comes down to simplicity, though. Anything comes to, you know, when you look at all the stuff and all the research that I've done, everything comes back to you have the ability to heal yourself, prevent aging, prevent stress, everything, if you just put a little bit of time and effort into your own body. And that is really the simple solution of reactivating your body's own self-healing mechanism. And of course, you do need some supplements and some things that they're just not available to help yourself, you know, preserve yourself and prevent degenerative illness.
All right, hope that answers your question, Brad. God bless you. Adam, Andrew, Missy, James, your calls are just 3 minutes away with Dr. Group in studio. I'm Alex Jones, Infowars.com. Tosh Plumlee, CIA contractor whistleblower on Benghazi. He wants to talk about Hillary Clinton. He's got more info for folks. That's coming up in the next segment. Then, in the last segment of the broadcast, I had asked McBreen and Dude to put together something tied into Red Dawn. They've kind of rushed this out, but it's good. They'll probably polish it up for next week, but we're going to air a special little Red Dawn intro that dovetails and ties into how our society is becoming like that movie itself. Many parallels in films that were showing dystopic tyrannies. You now look around you, it's become reality in many ways. And we're here trying to reverse getting into the position where tyranny completely takes over. Really, there's two parallel tracks, liberty and tyranny. And there's still a lot of freedom because we exercise it. But the tyrants are trying to train us to get rid of it and to follow whatever order they say. The largest homosexual group in the country just came out. So used to, I'd be nice and go, if it makes you feel better, I'll say gay. Because I don't have anything against anybody. But it's a political agenda using the fact that we're nice
to go, okay, don't use the term husband and wife or boy and girl now, and you're going to go in a bathroom with women, and your daughters are going to go in bathrooms with men, and you're going to use the words we say. Well, you know what? I'm going to use the word homosexual then. How's that sound? It's scientific, just like heterosexual. It isn't attacking you. And if I wanted to attack you, I could. It's my First Amendment. They're trying to get rid of free speech, folks. These people are totalitarians using different fake civil rights movements as they take all of our basic liberties. I want to go to Adam. I want to go to Andrew. I want to go to James and others that have been patiently holding for Dr. Edward Group to answer your questions. But any comment, because you've talked a lot about the attack on the genders. I mean, again, this is like a Twilight Zone episode that it's getting this naked. Do you think it's desperation by the system accelerating their timetable? We've always known Brave New World is a blueprint, a owner's manual, not a fiction book. In Huxley's own words, his brother ran the UN, Julian Huxley. Are they accelerating it because they're in trouble or because they're arrogant?
Both, probably. It's all about money and power and control. And, you know, if you have a whole society and a whole world that depends on credit cards and fake currency and the doctors and the pharmaceutical companies and the oil and gas industries and is reliant upon the government, then, you know, that's the situation that they want. I mean, you're easily controllable. You're sick all the time. You can't think for yourself. You're non-motivated. I mean, it's so hard to even find somebody to work these days. You know, the people we're interviewing, you know, half the time they'll show up in flip-flops and they'll want to dictate the hours to us. So it's really a combination of things, I think. It's getting, but at the same time, they also know people are waking up and they know that people are turning away from medications. They're also taking control of their health. They're realizing what's going on. So it's kind of, you know, an attack against each other, positive and negative right now. And I think it's accelerating on the negative side, but it's also accelerating on the positive side. And we're caught right in the middle of these times right now, especially with, you know, all these things leading up to financial collapse and all the other stuff. And so it's real important, I think, for people to understand what they can do to help protect their bodies and help protect their families, because you have to know the truth and then you can understand how the solutions to the truth so you can protect yourself.
Sure. Who have we had holding the longest? Is it Andrew or Adam? Andrew in New York. Thanks for holding. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. How's it going?
Good, brother.
All right. Well, thank you for taking my call. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
My question is for Dr. No, thank you, guys. My question is for Dr. Group. You know, that I'm really calling for my wife here, and it just so happens that she developed a cyst on her ovary a couple of months ago, and it really had been affecting her right side as it's on her right ovary. What recommendations do you have to help detox or to minimize the effect of the cyst? We already been to a doctor and gave her some hormones. It really messed up her whole balance of everything. So, you know, we're a little concerned about the process here and what we can do.
Sure. Well, obviously, he can't sit here and engage in medicine or whatever or his recommendations over the phone because he hasn't examined your wife, and that's probably even not his particular area. But what would you do yourself with your wife? What would your wife do, Dr. Group?
Well, what I always look at is what is the root cause of a woman getting any type of ovarian cysts. And the root cause of that is toxic food, toxic water, toxic beverages, toxic air. But really what we've noticed over the time is the accumulation of phytoestrogens, estrogen dominance. That's why the medical profession with hormones, most of the time it doesn't work. And their only solution is to go in and do a hysterectomy or do surgery and take the cysts out. What I would do is I would address the root cause of the problem, which is most likely iodine deficiency. You can link that to practically 99.5% of all ovarian cysts. And for that matter, any cysts in the body can be linked to an iodine deficiency. So
I know when cows and horses won't get pregnant, they up the iodine in their range cubes or in their candies. They call them candies or cereals, but they're basically just mineral and vitamin bars, sometimes with some molasses in them as a treat.
Right. So what you want to do is get rid of all the fluoride intake that's coming in, get rid of any type of chlorine exposure. A lot of skin care products, believe it or not, can cause ovarian cysts because they're high in fragrances and phthalates and plastics, and those are endocrine disrupting chemicals. So
all the weird hormones that are artificial get in there and then just jack with it, and then they want to mask the fact that that's happening with more hormones. It's like when five-year-olds go into puberty now, I hear they give them hormones to suppress it, not, hey, get your kid off the GMOs. You know, why is your five-year-old going into puberty now? It's, oh, we're going to give you more hormones to suppress that.
Right. It's not that hard when you just look at the problem and then the root cause of the problem and work on it that way. Instead of addressing the symptoms, which is what standard medicine does, you address the root cause. And that's cleaning up her diet, drinking pure, clean water, and supplementing with iodine, vitamin D also, vitamin B, and utilizing the body's self-healing mechanism to eradicate that cyst over a period of time.
God bless you, sir. Hope your wife gets better. I mean, they admit ovarian cysts, thyroid problems in women. I see the studies, the articles. They're just off the charts. And you go to medical doctors, most of them, some are good, and they just say, oh, here's this, here's that. They don't even ask, why is this increasing? They don't ask, why is breast cancer up?
Right. They don't want to know. I mean, the reason is they're making too much money treating breast cancer, and they're making too much money from all the people out there that are contributing thousands of dollars to all these pseudo organizations like the Walk for Breast Cancer.
Billions of dollars. They make millions per event.
American Cancer Society and all this other stuff, which all they're doing is feeding the problem. And it's going around in a circle.
And why is it always find the cure? Great. How about find why it's exploding and stop it?
Exactly.
How about find the reason?
Exactly.
That's how you really stop it. The cure is find out. It'd be like if cyanide was in a well, in a water supply, and half the town was dying. You wouldn't say, let's find a cure to cyanide. You'd say, stop drinking the water.
There's been many a people that have come up with the cure, including us when we were shut down in 1998 when we had our cancer and degenerative disease clinic, and many doctors killed over it. Because they don't want the information out to the public.
Remember in Australia about 4 years ago, the headline came out that Big Pharma planned to kill doctors and people that were criticizing vaccines and drugs. And it said stuff like, we need to take this person out in the memos.
Well, that's what happened.
Take them out.
From the 20s to the 50s, they pretty much burned all the natural books. They took out all the... outlawed all the natural springs across the nation, which people used to go drink the water and bathe in the springs to restore their health. The AMA is actually just now launching a whole attack against medical doctors that are using any type of natural methods. So, I mean, there's always been an attack, and there's a continued attack, except now that we have the internet, people are actually waking up and they're seeing the...
Yeah.
Reviews from third parties where we half the time we can't even post the reviews of all these people up there that are getting such good results. And it's changing people's lives. And we have the opportunity every day to go home and say we made a difference in
someone's
life today.
Let's go to Adam in Colorado. Thanks for holding her on the air.
Hi, Alex, Dr. Group.
Welcome.
My question for Dr. Group was about gallbladders. I don't have one. And I was just wondering what I'm in for. And Alex, I was going to humbly ask your permission to use your voice in my Kickstarter campaign for InfoWars the Game.
Well, I'd have to see what you're planning, and I'd have to sign off on it. I can't just give people permission to this or that, but I'll tell you have fair use rights, because I'm a public figure, to use samples of me in a video game, a movie, whatever, without asking. It can't be a huge substantive part. Because then if I say people can do that, I've had them actually then say, oh, really? I own your show. David Icke had that happen to him where he said, oh, yeah, people can, you know, copy this or use it. They said, oh, guess what? You can't now. It's not yours either. So there's a double side to that. But what's your comment or question for Group, my friend?
Well, he was asking about his gallbladder removed. And let me just touch on that. Again, it's one of those things where if you have problems with your gallbladder and you're having the pain,
he doesn't have one.
Medicine takes it out. Exactly what happened to him.
Instead probably. Of doing the gallbladder cleanse.
So what you want to do is you want to do a liver cleanse. And now that you have your gallbladder removed, your liver has to take on all the jobs of the gallbladder. So it's even more important to keep yourself doing eating clean, drinking clean, breathing clean, and also doing at least 2 to 3 liver cleanses.
And if you have the money, what about a glutathione IV?
Well, any IVs from a qualified natural practitioner are always going to be good. If you have the money for that, that's great. But it's still not going to purge the liver. It's like oil pulling when you do that oil on day 5 or day 6, whatever liver cleanse you're doing, that can actually grabs and pulls all those toxins out.
If you look at what's in your gallbladder, giant green and black balls, almost everybody has them. Imagine not having that. Where does all that stuff go?
It goes in the liver. It's stored in the liver. That's good why Lord. We have some people that have 3,000
callers, we're out of time. Tosh Plumlee coming up. Great job, Dr. Group. Thank you so much. Thanks, you're going to be on the Nightly News tonight. Bye. Tosh Plumlee is a living legend. He is one of the main whistleblowers in the congressional hearings with Frank Church, then in the Iran-Contra hearings in the 80s. And he could not lose his job because he was a legitimate whistleblower, continued to fly clandestine aircraft for the CIA and the Defense Department around the world. He retired 2 years ago. Facebook.com, Robert.Plumlee.5. We'll take you directly to his Facebook, or just Google Robert Tosh Plumlee, and one of the first things that comes up is his Facebook. We'll tweet out his Facebook at Real Alex Jones. And he joins us now because he's the first person to name names and come out from his Pentagon and NATO source exactly what Hillary was doing, the weapons transfer, how she was using the State Department to ship weapons so that the Pentagon and others couldn't have control and Congress couldn't see it. We now know she had third world dictators giving her money at her foundation that made $2 billion, $2 billion, to then take export bans off. We know she sent the weapons to al-Nusra, al-Qaeda, that's now ISIS. I want him to condense and just focus in on the time we have today. I appreciate him coming on. Now Hillary and the secret emails is coming out, and he's got questions for her specifically that we'll get to in the next segment. Only got a few minutes left in this short one. But Robert, I got to tell you, it's good news that Clinton's in so much trouble, and I think they want to bring her down because they know Benghazi's coming out, but that would end up bringing down the whole government, so they want to burn her for smaller stuff ahead of time. What do you think?
Well, I think you're right there, Alex. And again, thanks very much for having me on. I appreciate that.
Thank you, sir, for your courage.
What I think about that, yeah, I think there's getting ready to be a big explosion, not just on the Hillary thing, but all the way back to Benghazi and prior to Benghazi. Where I come in, if you remember, we talked about this on your program about 2 years ago. From information received about Stinger missiles, about weapons from the direct commercial sales program, and also weapons being pilfered from Libyan bunkers that were going back into the CIA annex at that point. During that time frame, that was partially vetted, but not completely vetted like it has been over this email scandal with Clinton. There's much more than just this email scandal with Clinton in reference to the international gun running that has been going on, which eventually involved Ambassador Stevens and the death or massacre of Ambassador Stevens and the other of his crew. Where the information that I had received was covered on your program and other programs, and also posted on my Facebook page under the heading of International Gun Running. It was alleged at that point that there were Stinger missiles that had gotten into radical hands out of Syria, and that was a question that was being asked to the State Department at that time through a series of dispatches by the ambassador on what to do about that information, about what they should do. I mean, you know, so now what I wanted to bring up here, and I'm trying not to ramble, we'll try to work into this and be a little more concise. There's a thing called SCIF, and that's in the Pentagon. And basically what it is, it's like a clearinghouse, like a fusion house. It's a SCIF, S-C-I-F, is a Sensitive Compartmented Information Facility. All information, for instance, like emails from ambassadors, intelligence gathering from whether it be NATO or France or Germany or whatever. All this information goes into a skiff or a clearinghouse, like a clearinghouse. Those things are in the the Pentagon, the White House Situations Room. All this kind of stuff goes into what they call a skiff. Those things are extremely sensitive. If you take any information out of a skiff outside that facility, you're in violation, period.
It's a felony. It's espionage. Stay there. You've got experience with this. Walk us through it. 18-minute segment coming up. You're going to have the floor completely, Tosh, to lay this out from the inside so people understand exactly how criminal Hillary is. And now we know what you said 2+ years ago here. It's all Hillary out of the State Department. This is big news, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, I look back on some of the guests we've had on, Tosh Plumlee in the top 5 or 10 biggest whistleblowers ever, not just on this show, but in the country's history. I mean, we've had almost all the top NSA whistleblowers on. In some cases, first. And I just thank God I'm still alive. But it shows how many good people there are in governments, in companies, out there. Most people in the government are very thankful for what Tosh Plumlee's doing and for what we're doing. That's why we end up getting the information. The problem is there's bad guys in government. The higher you go, the more of them there are, and they don't like us. The safety, because a lot of people have been killed that I've interviewed. Flat out murdered. The safety is in getting more people to speak out and tell the truth, and then they can't stop us. That's why they've been persecuting whistleblowers, going after the press so bad the last 6-7 years, is to create a chilling effect. Very bold move. But because of political correctness, Obama got away with persecutions of the press and of whistleblowers that Bush could have never gotten away with. I mean, it's been unprecedented. So Robert Tosh Plumlee, has laid it all out in articles and documents on his website. But here it is. Foreign governments gave millions to foundation while Clinton was the State Department. And man, I mean, they'd give $1 million, they'd give $2 million, $2 billion total. And the next week, she'd take an export ban off. Now, who'd ever heard of this export-import, section of the State Department for weapons? Well, you heard it if you listen here. And Plumlee said that's how she was doing it. Not just allowing the shipments, she was doing it. So who knows what's in there? And that's why Hillary thought she could get away with this, is that so many companies and others are involved in all this arms smuggling that they're not going to want this to come out. So what does it mean that it is coming out? I'm going to give Mr. Plumlee the floor now for the next 16 minutes we have left of this segment to walk through how this works, how these documents go into these clearinghouses, what it means she had a secret set of books. Remember, the head of the EPA had to step down over fake email. This is all illegal. Wiping her server is obstruction of justice. Now she's saying, it was classified retroactively. All the State Department internal communications are secret. They're all restricted. So, again, she's playing on the public's ignorance. Tosh Plumlee, go ahead and lay it out for us.
Okay, well, thank you, Alex. I appreciate all those nice comments. I have been blessed. In some cases, I've been cursed. Sometimes we don't want to know the things we know. They're just given to us. One of the reasons that a lot of people are coming forward in the past few years is because we have watched us, intelligence sources have watched a slow, steady infiltration, political infiltration, implementing gatekeepers within places like SCIFs and DIA and various places to suck up and make sure that the general public does not find out the illegal stuff that's going on in reference to international gun running. There's more money. You've heard me say this before on your program. There's more money in gun running than there is in drug running. I've been blessed, as you say, to be on both sides of the fence. Now, when we went on break before, we were getting into a skiff. When I came on your program back, I think it was 2013 or 2012, you were one of the first programs that I made the allegation that there were Stinger missiles missing from our arsenal. I made the allegation that there was high-impact weapons in Libyan bunkers that were not secure. I made the allegation at that point in time that And it's recorded before the fact. And I did that for my own protection before the fact, because sometimes sunshine is the best defense people like me and others have. But at that point in time, the ambassador was also aware of this information and was sending a series of emails back and forth to the State Department. Now, the information that I had given to your program was obtained from a very sensitive NATO, or three very sensitive NATO sources in Ukraine or around Ukraine. And it involved these Libyan weapons that were getting pilfered onto the black market and involved some of the Stinger missiles. I publicly went out and said that before the fact. Now, the way it works, that information had already been filtered back to the proper agencies, and it was within what they called a SCIF. Now, a SCIF is like a fusion center, a civilian fusion center, except a SCIF is a DIA, Pentagon, military, whatever. And it's like a clearinghouse where all information worldwide goes into different compartments. And SCIF simply means it's S-C-I-F. And it's a sensitive, compartmented information facility. It's a facility. It's an intelligence gathering facility. Now, those facilities are so secure that even if you misplace your badge and you can't swipe to get into that deal, you've got to go through hoops, unimaginable hoops from different people in security. In other words, you've got to go to the security office, you've got to talk to this guy, you've got to do that, you've got to explain to them why you don't have your badge, you've got to explain why that badge does not work. I mean, before you can even launch and get inside that SCIF. Now, also, when you get ready to complete your tour of duty for that day, that hour at that SCIF, you are cleared out of that SCIF. If you take, I mean, they look in your box, I mean, they look in your pants. In some cases, you've got to unzip your pants to a security agent if he wants you to do that, to make sure that you're not stuffing like Fawn, putting stuff in her brassiere when they were working in her and Ollie North were working inside the Pentagon. So you can't get stuff out of a SCIF. If you do, or you even attempt to, you're immediately in violation of security. And if you have a security clearance, even without due process of going to court, that security clearance is immediately pulled at that point in time until you can substantiate and prove to security that you're not doing espionage, or you're not taking that information out to sell it or divulge it to the media or whatever. If they even suspect that that's what you're doing, your security clearance at that point is suspended. Now, what does this mean as far as Hillary Clinton? I have no axe to grind against the Clintons. In other words, I'm not political. I could care less, you know. I could talk about it. But that's not what I'm here for. I'm going to try to stay focused on this one thing. Information came to a SCIF. Now, I'm going to pull it back to you and I. I came on your program, and I released information that was currently going to SCIFs, but it hadn't got there yet. Which I jumped the gun. I got the NATO information before my sources said, hey, we're going to make our classified field reports, and you know what happens from there. Yes, I do. You won't believe what's going on over here, Tosh. We have C-130s on a daily basis coming in with tons and tons of arms and ammunition that are being assimilated out into bunkers in Libya. Wow, I thought they were already in bunkers. They're telling me that this information is going to CIA safe houses in Jordan, Turkey, and Pakistan. I'm thinking, wow, man, I can't report this until I know specific. You've got to give me more than just what you say. Well, a few days later, it came out. I came on your program, and it was not released at the SCIF first. You were the SCIF that information was released to. You and three other alternative media programs, that information was released at that point in time. If I still had a security clearance, at that point right there, my clearance would have been lifted. Otherwise, I would have been in trouble. I would have to stand in front of the Attorney General and explain my actions of why I talked to you. Now, that was an allegation. It was not, some of it wasn't proven at that point in time. That's two years ago. Now, I don't want to run you over time here.
No, keep going. It's more than 2 years ago. You're on record. But please continue, because getting into now, Hillary's house of cards is coming down. It's now in the news that Obama is torpedoing her campaign. There's infighting going on.
All right. Now, at the same time that this information was going, the Attorney General and the DOJ was persecuting people for misplacing emails. So classified emails were being misplaced, or sections of those emails were being recapped to friends just in general conversations, and they were brought to trial. One of them is doing 3.5 years in prison because he released a sensitive email that was had been classified by a SCIF. Now, if I had taken servers home during my career and put them in the deal, I was immediately supposed to notify security, and they were supposed to take the Secret Service out to my house and make that house classified as a SCIF in order for me to be able to have that information in my possession at that particular house, whether it be on a non-classified server or even a government server. In other words, security had to be set up at my house in order to have that information at that location. My question I'm leading up to is, why is there a double standard in the security apparatus of this country that allows people, and I'm not going to say just Clinton, I'm going to say others. Petraeus got in a lot of trouble because he took a bunch of printed documents and put them in a drawer, and they used a sexual scandal and those deals to bring that man down and destroy his whole career for the rest of his life. Over what? He had a few papers, maybe 100, maybe 500, maybe 1,000, maybe a whole damn book, or maybe just one paper. But the point is, he had them in an unsecure facility. They were not in a compartmentalized security. They were scattered. Now we come up here and we've got a very high echelon, a Secretary of State, that now is sort of claiming someone else did this. She didn't know. Look, I testified and I was warned. Mr. Plumlee, if you discuss this outside this room, you will be charged. They even tried to file a charge on me when I was going to write a book, and that was way many years ago in 1980. And I was going to write a book called The Black Knights of Cuba. And then I was going to write a book called Deep Cover, Shallow Graves. And then I was notified, you've got to turn that manuscript over to them so that they can review it and redact, because you're giving up methods and procedures and you've taken things out of the SCIF that you wasn't authorized to do. Mr. Plumlee, you're going to go to jail if you continue on this road. Now, I don't want to get all hypered up here, but I also got IRS down on me for a total of 10 years because I was messing with SCIF stuff, classified information. In other words, I testified to committees. In other words, in the committees that classified my testimony top secret committee sensitive. And that meant that when I went back to review a year later to review to make sure and initial each paragraph that that information was right, they told me I couldn't see that information because it had since been classified and I didn't have a clearance. So therefore, I was gagged. If I went out and talked about what I had done, through Iran-Contra, the tail numbers, the aircraft numbers, working with Barry Seal, working with all kinds of different people, talking about Santa Elena, Costa Rica. I just violated a whole bunch of them just now. So, you know, I mean, what does all that mean?
It means Hillary Clinton thinks she's above the law, but obviously she isn't. And when you talk about the State Department and arms smuggling and that Hillary was involved, that has now, years later, all come out. This is a big, big deal. And then you've got questions for Hillary. We should go over some of these questions, Tosh.
Good. Appreciate that. Yeah, you do them. I don't have my copies here because I can't get on.
All right, well, they're up on your Facebook. Let's go over some of these questions. Ms. Clinton, while you were Secretary of State, Were you aware that the U.S. weapons were being obtained from U.S. arsenals in Libyan bunkers and being transferred to CIA contract employees in Jordan and Turkey? Number two, were you, Ambassador Stevens, and the U.S. State Department aware of U.S. weapons?
Sure.
It continues. Were you, Ambassador Stevens, and the U.S. State Department aware U.S. weapons were being pilfered from those stockpiles and being sold on the black market in Libya, effectively falling into radical factions operating in and out of Syria? Number three, were you aware that Ambassador Stevens was concerned about the loss of American weapons, and if he mentioned this in a series of dispatches to the U.S. State Department while you were Secretary of State? And you go on to say these are some of the main questions. Why are these the most important questions, Tosh?
Well, those are questions that are embedded within that skiff that I made reference to. So the question is, she says yes, or she says I cannot answer those. Those are a matter of classified, that's classified information, or just a flat standard answer. I can't answer that. I can't answer that. I can't answer that. Why did you take that questions home with you? Why did you take that sensitive information that you just admitted by not answering yes or no to those three questions, let alone the 11 Benghazi questions? Why is it that you can't answer those three simple questions, yes or no? Did you know that Ambassador Stevens had contacted the State Department requesting what he should do with the information that he had received, that radicals out of Syria had just received 400 Stinger missiles from the U.S. arsenals that were shipped on C-130s to the Middle East? Now, if they say, oh, well, that's an allegation, get the flight plans of the C-130s and the refueling from the 339th or whatever. I just did something there I shouldn't have done. But there are a lot of things I shouldn't have done. But ask those questions. If she said no, and later we find out through the emails when they're going to be scrubbed. I mean, they've been scrubbed, but they're going to be found. There's going to be enough information come out that at least will point in that direction that she did know, and she took that information home. So she can't answer that as classified. Did she make the judgment that that question is a classified question? If she had that kind of sense, then she can't. How can
well,
she
obviously, that's why the head of the EPA had to resign, was using a dummy email and nom de plumes. I mean, Hillary did the same thing with code names. She was doing illegal activity. And who knows if these are even all the emails that they say they've turned over and it's all scrubbed. I mean, right there, she is as guilty as a cat caught in the canary cage. Let me ask you this when we come back, Tosh. We got to go to break.
Okay.
Why do you think they're going after her? I mean, I think they're going after on smaller things, you agreed, because they know the big stuff's about to come out. I know you still talk to folks inside these different agencies. What's their take on this? And we'll do a little bit of overdrive as well with Robert Tosh Plumlee. We'll also tweet out at Real Alex Jones, his Facebook, where this is all located, the articles, the documents, and more, so the radio listeners can follow along with what we've been showing on TV. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones. There is no doubt that the people that have taken over our government, criminal elements, are trying to set up a domestic police state. They're trying to set up a system to take out constitutionalists, not liberals, not conservatives, but people that understand that we're under social engineering and that it's classical tyranny. We're going to do 20 minutes of overdrive to take your phone calls for questions for Robert Tosh Plumlee, the guy that blew the whistle on Benghazi from high-level sources in NATO and the Pentagon and everything he talked about. It's actually about 3 years ago, and then again 2 years ago, has now all come out. Colonel Schaefer also, about 2 weeks after, said it was missiles and an arms deal. He got called in and threatened to be basically arrested. I'm not even supposed to even get into all this. But a lot of threats have been thrown around about this. So it's Tosh Plumlee. Colonel Schaefer's been willing to talk about it. But the good news is there's a lot of people behind the scenes that are talking about it. We only got a minute or two before break. We'll come back and you'll have the floor and then take calls. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231 on Benghazi. But in 1 minute, Robert, why do you think it looks like they're getting ready to bring down Hillary as the fall guy to cover up the larger Benghazi?
Well, okay. I'm not a conspiracy person, as you know, Alex. But, okay, they're throwing Hillary Clinton under the bus. This is a dog and pony show that we're, the American people are being fed. It's straight a dog and pony show. This is a diversion. The emails and all that and her violating the law, was there an end time, the Attorney General and the Department of Justice, especially the FBI, they will get to the bottom of that. And then it's all over. But right now we're being fed a dog and pony show. And the secret government is throwing Hillary Clinton under the bus in order to cover up the Benghazi situation. The Benghazi situation.
Stay there. Back in 70 seconds, Tosh. You'll flesh it out straight ahead. Some stations don't carry it. Infowars.com/show to find the free. Your chance to talk to Robert Tosh Plumlee, 800-259-9231. I'm glad that our reporters realize how big this interview is. Leanne McAdoo is host of the Nightly News tonight. She just ran in here and said, can you ask Robert Tosh Plumlee, who got cut off by the break, to repeat that? So there's not music playing over it. Absolutely, to restate what he said. I had asked the question, and I'll do it again right now and go to him. Robert, they're clearly throwing Hillary under the bus now. Now they're saying in the Washington Times, Obama is, quote, torpedoing her campaign. I think she's a vile, horrible person, but clearly you're non-political. You've said you want the truth of Benghazi to come out. A, do you agree with me that it looks like she's in deep trouble and they may be getting ready to flush her? And then B, why would they be doing that right now, Tosh Plumlee?
Well, okay. We're in a diversion right now, zeroed in on Clinton and emails that were taken, classified emails that were taken out of the deal. The reason that they're zeroing in on this dog and pony show and the Trump and all this and stuff is simply for one reason, my opinion, and also documented. The Benghazi murder massacre was only because the ambassador found out about a very secret international gun running operation that it involved U.S. Stinger missiles, and he had the opportunity to purchase those Stinger missiles back to get them off of the international market. So he could buy those Stinger missiles back. This is classified information that I'm talking about. This is the kind of information that is in those skiffs. Now, he had an opportunity to buy that back. So they was told to stand down. Shortly after that, he's dead. The reason that she's being thrown onto the bus and the reason for this diversion is that they will not let us get into the fact that the ambassador had uncovered this gun running operation and was asking the U.S. State Department how he should handle it. What should he do with this information that he had received from on the ground, boots on the ground, informants, some of them American, some of them NATO. If you remember, NATO went in to those Libyan bunkers to clear them out. Where did those weapons go, and what were those weapons? This is what they don't want us to know.
And you also use the term secret government. Repeat that. Talk about the secret government and how it operates.
Well, we have a segment. And I don't want to get into conspiracy stuff and so on like that, but we have a situation that goes all the way back to before Kennedy that has been gradually, I call it the American slow coup d'etat. We have an element, whether it be international, whether it be whatever, and I don't get into all that kind of stuff, but we have a situation that has been developing for years, a slow and gradual infiltration into the CIA, into various political organizations, and it is like a secret government within itself. They manipulate. They are the gatekeepers. They stop information like what I'm talking about. They tried to stop me for a lot of years, but that's the problem right now. So now this situation of exposing this gun-running operation that goes all the way back to at least Iran-Contra, and that's what Iran-Contra is, same M.O., you get an operation going, you operate it, you tweak it, you dust it off, you put it on the shelf, and then at the proper time, you bring that operation back, you modify it a little bit, and you put it back out in the field for operatives like me to carry out, or others. So, again, back to why you asked me what they're doing. They're throwing Hillary under the bus. They're giving us a dog and pony show. They're contaminating. They work for news sources. They won't let senior editors ask certain questions. The three questions that I just asked Hillary Clinton, why doesn't our mainstream media just ask her those three questions?
Sure, this is obviously the scandals tied to Benghazi. Why won't they put the horse with the carriage?
So to sum it up, what you just said, to sum it up in one sentence, the cover-up is international gun running into Benghazi that got an ambassador murdered. Massacred.
All right, stay there, Tosh. We're coming back with phone calls straight ahead in Overdrive, Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.com. Robert Tosh Plumlee is our guest. I want to go to loaded phone calls for him here in just a moment. Former CIA contractor, whistleblower on Benghazi. Other points you'd like to add before we go to these calls, Robert?
Well, just other than to sum it up, that we talked about this as an allegation, what, 3 years ago, two and a half, 3 years ago? And now it's all those allegations from two and a half, 3 years ago that was out here on your program have now been confirmed from more than one source, from multiple sources, and including mainstream media, who has been extremely reluctant over the years to even touch this stuff because of gatekeepers that imposed upon them as senior editors that keep good reporters from doing their job, reporting this stuff. This information that I'm talking to you on your camera eyeball to eyeball about has been out there. It's been out there for 3 years. It's been vetted. It's been vetted by military sources and pilots that actually flew those guns and ammunition to Jordan and Turkey and the CIA annex and Libya. Jim Mars, a friend of mine, has written about it. He was on your program. We talked about it. The direct commercial sales program has been a cash cow for political interest in this country. A lot of people don't know what the direct commercial sales program is.
Well, it's got to be great for her. She runs the State Department.
That's
third world countries, foreign countries, dictators pay her money to her foundation, and then she takes the restriction off or secretly ships the weapons.
Well, here's the deal, right? And that she uses that as, or they, somebody uses that as a cutout. But the point being is those weapons. And the direct commercial sales program and the Blue Lantern report that authorized weapons sales to foreign countries is controlled and monitored by the U.S. State Department. So therefore, when someone makes an application to ship high-impact weapons from the U.S. arsenal, they have to get approval. There's forms to fill out. Foreign interests are involved. They have to make sure they're not tied with a foreign country in order to get approval by the State Department to ship those arms out of this country or take those arms out of our arsenal. In this case, we ship hundreds of thousands of arms to Libya. When the Libya fell, those arms are in bunkers. We sent, and according to the Washington Post, confirmed what I told you, we sent CIA contractors to those safe houses, to the bunkers and the safe houses, to remove those weapons. What were they trying to remove them for? I mean, why didn't they C-130s? Why didn't those C-130s fly those weapons back to this country instead of taking them to the CIA annex and then also putting them on a ship from Tripoli and going into radical hands? For instance, John McCain, and I have nothing against John McCain. Real fast, I know we're on time element here.
Yeah, he's attacked you.
Yeah, he attacked me right out, saying something about I said when the question was raised about missiles. He also said pigs fly and the sun rises in the west. Okay, I didn't attack that man. Well, so why did that man make a statement? But 2 weeks, here's the facts. 2 weeks after that, photographed in brand new Toyota pickup trucks with a 50 caliber machine gun mounted on the back, slinging a U.S.-made Stinger missile over their shoulder, flying the ISA flag. Now, wait a minute. Come on. I didn't never say pigs fly and the sun sets in the west. I said simply this. ISA has Stinger missiles, and they got them from Libyan bunkers, period. Now, that should have been investigated. What, by the U.S. State Department.
Well, it just shows that they think if you're the Attorney General or the Vice President or the President or the Secretary of State, you're allowed to commit crimes out in the open, and they're not invincible. It's like Nixon said, well, when you're president, something's not illegal when it's normally illegal. Well, that was proven wrong right there, and I think if Hillary falls, it's going to spread to others. I don't think they're going to be able to compartmentalize it, but I think they want to discredit her in case she shoots her mouth off, but we'll see what happens. Let's go to some calls. Let's talk to Wild man in Texas. You're on the air with Tosh Plumley. Go ahead.
Thanks for taking my call, and God bless you both. Thanks to you all both for what you do. And as a matter of fact, I think the United States is in the toilet bowl and vortex of the toilet bowl flux as we speak, and it's like a giant alcoholic, and it's not going to get any better until we hit bottom. But my question for Mr. Plumley is, in the Benghazi murders at the hand of behest of Hillary Clinton and all the weapons that were took from those warehouses, a few months ago you was on Alex's show and you said you was going to go investigate the two training camps that ISIS has across the southern border in Mexico. And I was wondering, do you think that any of those weapons that was took from them warehouses ended up down there that will end up across the border here to be used against us?
Well, okay. Wild man from Texas. You're not one of my relatives, are you? Okay. Back when we had this great big other diversion about little kids coming across the border and all this kind of stuff, that was a diversion to take us away from Fast and Furious. The training camps, what I meant about that was more than actual training camps, is that there was infiltration from Somalis coming across through the southern borders from Mexico and Guatemala, and they were bringing some of these pilfered weapons in through Mexico into the United States, into CIA safe or into ISA safe houses that was operating in Atlanta, Georgia, and Las Vegas. That was the story at that time. If you notice, it did not go anywhere because it was overshadowed about little kids that was bringing hoop and cough.
Sure, and by the way, Joe Biggs got visited by the FBI, a reporter. They said they find the reports of Judicial Watch, who has the documents, very credible that there are ISIS bases over the Texas border, like you said, to fund operations with human smuggling as a business and weapon smuggling, because ISIS is an organized crime system.
Well, that's what's happening. We have breadcrumb. ISA has breadcrumb strategic places throughout the world that is just like the Underground Railroad back in the Civil War days. You pass on, pass on, pass on. You break weapons down. You send them by piecemeal through little kids and backpacks. You send them with the drugs. Well, I take that back. You don't send them with the drugs because they're zeroed in on those drugs so much. They tell them by other ways. They just drive them across the border. You can't get a 50 caliber machine gun out of the United States and drive it across the Mexican border into Mexico, but you can get a 50 caliber machine gun out of Mexico into the United States.
Listen to this.
Extremely easy.
Joe Biggs and our reporters were down there just on July 23rd. And they were down there right on the Texas border, and a truck with like 10 different packages, probably marijuana, but it could have been weapons, anything, huge boxes, just loaded in a truck and drive away. And right as the drug truck comes up, the Border Patrol is parked 100 yards away. They drive off the other way. And Joe Biggs said it looked completely staged.
Well, there's all kinds. Now we're getting off into other things, but yes, there's all kinds of things. Border Patrol they have their hands full. There's damn good people in Border Patrol. In fact,
no, I know there is, but we also know some have been paid off.
Oh, yes, 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 sir. And there's a lot of them right here out of Las Cruces and around in Santa Teresa and others that are damn good. And they weed out their own. And there's also down in Piedras Negras and the Falcon Lake situation. They know what's going on down there. They understand that exactly. We had a meeting with intelligence unit here for the sectors 2 years ago. It was written up in SalemNews.com. About having a meeting with them to talk about exactly what we're doing right now. We warned them at that point that drones at that early date 3 years ago was carrying weapons across the border, dropping them. They wasn't carrying just drugs on and dropping them. They were using ultralights and all kinds of different things to pick them up and drop them across the border. We lost a very good Border Patrol guy by the name of, well, we know who Terry was. And the Peck Canyon massacre, I call it. I mean, good gosh, we could go on and spend hours and hours and days of talking about what's been going on that border, and then that leads us into the political side of it and building great big walls and all that kind of stuff. But the point is this: weapons have been coming, not going from Mexico, from the United States to Mexico. They've been weapons coming from the Middle East through Guatemala, through Mexico.
Sure, Fast and Furious is a distraction.
Yes.
Small arms from the U.S. going into Mexico. the drug cartels, mainly for whatever reason, have a fetish with German weapons, is what I've read, and that's what they're buying is full auto. They're not buying German full auto at gun shops here in the U.S.
The point is this. They're stashing these things, and they got training sites. If you want to call them training sites, it could be, or they're flop houses, or they're safe houses, and they're getting ready to do it. Whenever it is, intelligence will tell you that. The information that I'm telling you right now is being assimilated in those skiffs that I mentioned earlier on your program. This is not supposed to be out to the American people. You know why? Oh, they can't handle the truth.
That's right. We're skipping this break, going to the bottom of the hour in overdrive. Frank in Florida, thanks for holding her on the air with Tosh Plumley.
Thanks, Wild Man. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get off on that.
No, you answered his question well. Go ahead, Frank.
Yeah, Mr. Thumley, I definitely want to tell you it's a great honor. I do have a question for you, and then I have some major intel I wanted to go over off air with somebody from your staff, Alex. The question I have for you, Mr. Plumley, in my upbringing in New York, I had the chance to run across several people that on various levels have been in close contact with the Clintons over the years. What I'm getting from somebody very deep inside close to them is that the most potential damaging information within the emails that have been seized, or at least what they're looking for, has been satellite imagery as well as drone footage that followed the importation of the weapons into the Benghazi area, as well as everybody involved in the handling of them, as well as what they dubbed later on as being the protesters, which did lead to Ambassador Stevens' unfortunate end. I just was curious in your circles if you've heard anything of the same.
Well, when we're getting into satellite imagery, there was a lot of satellite imagery about weapon shipments going back and forth across the borders into Benghazi. In fact, the ambassador was responsible for alerting the State Department to that satellite imagery. That's what, in a way, is what started all this stuff.
And so that's why they sent the local security force that they admittedly had hired al-Qaeda to kill him to get rid of the evidence because they wanted to launch the next phase, bringing down Syria.
He was told to stand down on the information that he was passing to the State Department, and the question is, who in the State Department told him to stand down?
Gee, I wonder who was heading up the State Department.
Well, and also weapons shipments, and then also you look at campaign contributions. I slid a little Freudian slip there. Maybe I shouldn't have done that, but follow the money. If a person can get $2.5 million for talking, why aren't I getting $2.5 million for talking to you? A speaking engagement and all this kind of stuff. Why is it that secret monies and slush funds and secret bank accounts being filtered and cut out and going like that? What I'm trying to say, and again, I'm going to qualify, I don't have anything axe to grind against the Clintons. It's an operation. It's been an operation that's been going on for a long time. There's more people involved in this than just the Clintons. Than Hillary Clinton. The point being is that there's corruption at the highest levels, and they will sacrifice their own just like a wolf gnawing his leg to get out of a trap. In other words, that's where we're at right now with the Clintons. We got them fighting among themselves, gnawing at her leg to put her under the bus in order to save one thing. What's the motive? Follow the money, and also to stop what the ambassador had already reported to the State Department through proper channels, that there was Stinger missiles going to the radicals in Libya.
What are they going to do when the al-Qaeda people, who we know are wind-up toys of the shadow groups that they use to take our liberties, they use the threat to take our liberties, what are they going to do when they start shooting down Western airliners? How are they going to cover that up? Claim the Russians did it or something?
Well, sure, there's going to be another diversion to that. I mean, that could happen any time now. I mean, look, a Stinger missile shot down one of our helicopters and a lot of good men got killed. Okay, that's pushed under the rug. It wasn't a Stinger missile, it was an RPG. Wait a minute. Anybody that's been in the military that's ever fired an RPG knows it's damn near impossible to shoot a moving target, especially a helicopter with an RPG, even if the helicopter's flying 200 feet off the ground. I mean, that's a phenomenal feat, and would take someone that has been highly trained on an RPG in order to be able to pull that feed off. So it was shot down by a Stinger missile, and the ambassador knew it. He reported it. It went to, quote, a skiff, like a clearinghouse, to be evaluated. Did it have any merit? Were there any missing missiles? How come the missiles were photographed in the back of trucks? These are things that intelligence officers and intelligence people.
How come ISIS is in U.S. Special Forces Toyotas fitted here in the United States by the hundreds? How come they're driving around in U.S.-made MRAPs, which the Iraqis didn't even have? How come they've been photographed with the Stinger missiles in the back of trucks? Exactly. They were supplied by the State Department to be the army of the Saudi Arabian takeover.
Well, the State Department would use a cutout on that. Otherwise, but the point being, it was approved by the State Department to go to a subcontractor or a series of subcontractors to carry out and implement to get those deals in there. It's a money deal. It's not that they're saying, okay, we want to support ISIS to overthrow and cut people's heads off. No, we can make $500 million if we let them have that Toyota truck and if we let them mount that 50 cal or if we give them those Stinger missiles. The ambassador wanted to buy back those Stinger missiles for $50,000 a missile, and he was denied. In other words, he would stand down.
No, I hear you. That is just insane.
And who did that? The State Department did that. Now, did Hillary Clinton do that? I don't know. But ask her those three questions, and if she says yes or no, or they're classified, then I want to know why the ambassador was killed.
Let's move quick now. Thank you, Frank. Good points. Anthony in Florida, you're on the air. Quick question. I want to get a lot in now.
Okay. I'm sorry if I rattled
you. No, you're great. Go ahead.
I just have a question for Tosh Plumlee. What is his thoughts on the fact that it's pretty obvious that NATO is trying to pick a fight with Vladimir Putin, basically reigniting the Cold War? Because as far as I'm concerned, they can't sell us this fake war on terror. And so I was wondering, what is his thoughts on them trying to pick a fight with
Putin? Sure, the new Cold War with massing troops and weapons all around Russia right now. That's official. Thank you, Anthony. Good question. Tosh?
Very good. Anthony, everybody right now, international, saying is jockeying for position. That's the whole thing. Why are they jockeying for position? Again, it's a money deal, the IMF, whatever you want to call it. So is Putin starting a war with NATO, the Ukraine? I mean, but when you get all through whatever their motives are, the bottom line is follow the money. Russia is broke. The United States is broke. The only way to solve being in poverty as a nation is to start a war, start a brush war, sell the weapons. That's where your money comes from. In other words, the reason they got into weapons and drugs is that there's a hell of a lot of money in drugs that can buy the weapons. But when you can buy the weapons and triple your money on the black market, it doesn't matter. Politics doesn't play into that.
Sure. Well, it's one thing to sell AK-47s to Al-Qaeda. That's bad enough. To give them Stinger missiles just shows this elite is completely out of their minds. They'll never cover that up. Thank you so much, Tim. Great question. Or did I just hang up another caller? Is Tim next? Tim in FEMA Region 9, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hello, Tosh and Alex. I'll make this quick. I was in Israel from 74 to 80, and I'm just saying that I was working there. When we came across information on Red Eye and Stinger missiles, close to 10 to 15,000 of them that had been brought into Libya, which subsequently wound up in Afghanistan when the Russian forces were there. And we turned all that information over to the Mossad and Shin Bet at that particular time. But it was so this has been going on for close to 30 years or more. And if I can state one more thing, is that we're not going to stop this. There's no way it can be stopped. The only thing that we can do is inform people. So that was basically my comment.
Well, where do you think all this is going, and what is the point of giving Al-Qaeda, under all these new names, 400 Stinger missiles?
What it's about is, you see, in order to understand what's taking place in current events today, we must keep our eye on Israel and what's going to take place there. Because this all ties into biblical prophecy as to bringing this, because, you know, God is not going to allow this thing to go on forever. And his prophetic time clock is winding down. This is bringing us up to Ezekiel chapter 38, the battle of Gog and Magog, and the other nations, Gomer and all of her bands, which is Germany, the European Union, and so forth. They are marching towards this in order to bring in, to facilitate, a new world order, a one-world government, which is satanically controlled.
I agree with you. God bless you. I appreciate your call. You know, I'm sorry to Jay and Michael and others. Tosh, you've got about a minute for closing comments. Thank you so much.
Okay, well, I'm going to close up real fast here. This was exposed on your program, if you want to call it that, 3 years ago. It has now been vetted and confirmed. As far as Hillary Clinton, in my personal opinion, if they're going to put other people in jail that have done a lot less than her because of emails, then she should be indicted. No question about that. As far as the gun and arms deal, it's going to continue, like the gentleman just said. It's been going on for over 30 years. I've been involved in one way or another with this for damn near all my life. The only reason I'm out public is to protect my butt. That's all. I'm not out here making any money off this, doing that, something like that. I wish I had a couple of Stinger missiles to sell right now. So I'm not any different than them, you know. So there we are, you know. So anyway, God bless you. All your listeners, if I can help, I'm there. That's the reason I opened up the Facebook page, is to bring all this information together into one place so that you, the public, can decipher it and vet it and then try to do something about it.
Well, Tosh, great job exposing this, because this is really important. I mean, it'd be one thing if somebody sold Stinger missiles to a friendly government. You don't sell them to Al-Qaeda. It's completely evil, and it shows how crazy the elite are. Nightly news tonight's going to be big. Thank you, Tosh. Great job, crew.
Thank you, Alex.
Thank you. 7 o'clock Central, Prison Planet.